weeks of the drug from $13.50 per pill to $750 per pill. The price increase raised the average treatment cost for patients from about $1,130 a year to $63,000. Certain patients may need to pay up to $634,000 each year for Doripirim treatments. Doripirim treats toxoplasmosis, an infection caused by the Toxoplasma gondii parasite, one of the world's most common parasites. Although toxoplasmosis is not considered dangerous in people who are generally healthy, for people who are pregnant or have a weakened immune system, the effect of the infection can be severe. CBS News correspondent Don Dollar asked Shkreli, "Why is it necessary to raise the price of Doripirim so drastically?" Shkreli responded, "Well, it depends on how you define so drastically. Because the drug was unprofitable at the former price, so any company selling it would be losing money. And at this price, it's a reasonable profit, not excessive at all." The price of Doripirim was about $1 per pill several years ago before it was acquired by Cor Pharma. Shkreli added, "This isn't the greedy drug company trying to gouge patients. It is us trying to stay in business."
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports plans to avert a U.S. government shutdown began taking shape in the Senate on Tuesday, but it was still far from certain whether a dispute over funding for women's healthcare group Planned Parenthood could be overcome. With only days remaining before an October 1st deadline, Senate leaders said they were pursuing a stopgap funding bill to extend the present federal budget for about 10 weeks beyond the September 30th end of the fiscal year. Senior senators from both parties said a continuing resolution was gaining traction. The Senate's continuing resolution approach may fail if conservative Republicans in the House of Representatives stand by their threat to oppose any spending plan that preserves federal funding for Planned Parenthood. President Obama and congressional Democrats oppose defunding the group, which has said it has done nothing wrong and blasted the allegations as deceptive and unfair. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The FAA has issued a reminder that any plane can crash and kill you. Deputy FAA Administrator Serena Grant.
This year, there will be more flights than ever. Any one of them could blow up in the middle of the sky without warning. That's why we're asking all Americans to tell their families that they love them before taking off.
The agency also released a list of important questions to ask yourself or your seatmate during your flight, including, should the wing be doing that? What is that whirring noise? And do all planes shake this much? They're reminding passengers that even the smallest amount of turbulence could mean you're headed toward a sudden explosive death. While hurtling through the sky at unimaginable speeds in a steel coffin can feel like gambling with your life, the FAA says there are ways to regain the illusion of control.
If you're worried about crashing, why not switch your flight at the last second? It might just save your life. Or kill you, depending on which plane crashes.
And for those who aren't flying this holiday, the FAA has reminded everyone that a plane could fall out of the sky right on top of you at any moment.
This is the Onion News Network.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Terrence.
Ah, early.
Happy birthday to you.
Can anybody sing that song and it'd be good? I mean, it's so flat.
I don't know. I've never really heard that good of a version of it.
Well, there's Marilyn Monroe who managed to pull it off, but she kind of did it in a very whispery way.
It's a boring song.
It really is.
Wasn't it based on another tune anyway?
They all are.
Yeah.
The national anthem's a British drinking song.
So it's not Taryn's birthday, but next
it's
week
coming
apparently,
up. Yeah,
right?
The first.
So you know,
everybody
figured,
block their schedule out.
What do you say when it's when it's after your birthday? It's belated. What do you say if it's prior to
pre-birthday.
Pre-birthday.
My birthday goes all month, so this will be...
Is that legit, though? Is that like an actual term, or did you just make that up?
No, I've used it. I don't know if it's real or not. So pre-birthday.
The reason I broke into song here at the beginning of the show is there's news. This is I consider to be big news. Happy birthday copyright claims have been ruled invalid, according to a federal judge. Now, we'll give you our phone numbers here and the Skype. You can join us. You can talk about anything you want here on Free Talk Live. But for a long time, the song Happy Birthday has been locked down by its owners.
Right.
By,
this is the reason that they'll sing things at restaurants that, you know.
Happy birthday.
You know, that kind of thing. But they don't sing Happy Birthday. Thank God. I mean, it's really not that good of a song, but everybody knows it. Everybody knows how to sing it. They know what the next line is and all that stuff. So it's ubiquitous in that fashion.
How old is it? Like, when was
old.
It? Old. When was it wrote?
More than 100 years ago, from what I understand here. It's been. Let's see. I've got the details.
It was a repurposed song, as I understand it.
Well,
from the Los Angeles Times, none of the companies that have collected royalties on the Happy Birthday song for the past 80 years held a valid copyright claim to one of the most popular songs in history, according to a federal judge in Los Angeles yesterday. In a stunning reversal of decades of copyright claims, the judge ruled that Warner Chappell never had the right to charge for the use of the Happy Birthday to You song. Warner had been enforcing a copyright since 1988 when it bought Birch Tree Group, the successor to Clayton F. Summey Co., which claimed the original disputed copyright. Judge George H. King ruled that a copyright filed by the Summey Co. in 1935 granted only the rights to specific piano arrangements of the music, not the actual song. Randall Newman, attorney for the plaintiffs in the suit, including a group of filmmakers who are producing a documentary about the song, said that Happy Birthday is finally free after 80 years. Finally, the charade is over. It's unbelievable. A spokesman for Warner Chappell, the publishing arm of Warner Music, said, quote, "We are looking at the court's lengthy opinion and considering our options." Unquote. The plaintiff's attorneys had characterized the years-long legal fight as a David versus Goliath battle that pitted independent filmmakers against a large corporation. That's Warner Music, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Collecting profits on a song whose authors had long since died. And until now, Warner has asked for royalties from anyone who wanted to sing or play Happy Birthday to You with the lyrics as part of a profit-making enterprise. Royalties.
Because they couldn't do it without the lyrics. Because that song was not
another
even
song.
Wasn't written by them. That just the lyrics were owned.
Yeah, I think it was a couple ladies in the late 1800s that wrote it. Anyway, royalties were most often collected from stage productions, TV shows, movies, or greeting cards. But even those who wanted to sing the song publicly as part of a business, say a restaurant owner giving out a free birthday cake to patrons, technically had to pay to use the song, prompting creative renditions at chain eateries trying to avoid paying royalties, which kind of one of the, I guess, benefits of it is, as you pointed out, Mark, this song is kind of dull, but the fact that people couldn't use it meant that they had to get creative and come up with something different. The fact that, but of course, that also meant that the family who was sitting there that was enjoying the birthday could not sing along with whatever song was being sung because nobody knows the Olive Garden version of Happy Birthday, you know, except for the Olive Garden employees. The fact that the birthday tune can't be played or sung without permission from Warner has been little more than a surprising piece of trivia for most. But for Warner Music Group, it has meant big business. Two of the filmmaker plaintiffs paid $1,500 and $3,000 for the rights to use the song, their attorneys said. Filmmaker Steve James.
Yes, they're going to be getting that money back.
Paid Warner $5,000, another filmmaker, to use the song in his 1994 documentary, Hoop Dreams.
I got to say, it's not that impressive as far as a dollar, you know, like a price tag.
No, I mean, considering that it costs
$3,000?
Over $1 billion to make a movie these days, you know.
Yeah, but not when you're making a documentary. I mean,
Rolling Stones to endorse the Cadillac, on the other hand, that's an entirely different story, right?
$3,000 would have been more than double my budget for Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree.
For a small independent, it would be crushing.
Yeah, it would be big, but think about what Iron Man paid to, is it Iron Maiden? I'm not entirely sure who does Iron Man, but I am Iron Man.
You know, no, that's,
Led Zeppelin?
No.
No.
One of those hard rock songs. Anyway.
Yeah.
Oh my
the old
gosh,
Aussie
I can't
band.
Believe I
the
forgot
old Aussie
it.
Band.
Is it?
Black Sabbath.
Yeah, there
Black
you go.
Black Sabbath. Yeah.
So, yeah, whatever they paid to these you know, these bands in order to play these songs, I mean, that's a significantly larger sum. And we're basically talking about the same thing here. The rights to a song.
Well, and who knows, Mark? I mean, maybe they would charge a major film production even more money. Maybe they just arbitrarily
I'm sure they
decide.
Would.
Yeah. At March.
It's arbitrary. Look, there's three different films there that paid three different prices, $3,000 to $5,000.
It may have to do with how much of the song they used. As one of the filmmakers points out, Steve James says, quote, "It was quite expensive for us at that time and with our budget, and we only used it for 9 seconds.
Wow.
James wrote in an email passed by his publicist saying the scene was essential to the film, and ultimately he paid up. At a March hearing in the case, records show Warner Chappell's representative seated in the audience told the judge the company collects as much as six figures for certain single uses of the song. So if you're making Iron Man, it might be $500,000.
Wow. Well, how many seconds are you guys allowed to play in radio before you got to pay for it?
I think it's 7 seconds for fair use.
Honestly, I have no idea.
The
well,
bumper,
no, fair
the
use.
The rejoiners.
Well, I don't know what fair use's rules are, Mark, but fair use basically means there are certain circumstances under which you can use copyrighted material if it's like, for instance, for political commentary purposes and there's other certain reasons you can use it. So in theory, you could probably comment on an entire song.
So if we were, for instance, doing the show and the verdict went the other way, we could still play Happy Birthday on the air to let people know what it was that we were talking about, that kind of thing?
Maybe. Fair use is kind of a murky area, though.
It's murky as hell, I'm sure.
It's like we could review the song by playing it and talking about it, but we couldn't play it for pleasure. Is that what you mean?
Essentially, from what I understand. Now, look, I'm not an attorney, so if you want to learn more about fair use, there's a pretty detailed Wikipedia article about it. But it's, you know, like a lot of things in the legal land, it is subject to the interpretation of a man in a robe. So if the man in the robe doesn't think that what you're doing was fair use, then you're going to owe some money. That's why people tread very, very carefully when it comes to these areas. The song brings in about $2 million a year in royalties for Warner, according to some estimates. The complex saga of the eight-note ditty has spanned more than 120 years, withstanding two world wars and several eras of copyright law. The song has seen the rise and fall of vinyl records, cassette tape, CDs, and now the era of digital streaming music. The story began in 1893. There's the answer to your question earlier.
People always want to know.
With a Kentucky school teacher and her older sister, Patty Smith Hill and Mildred J. Hill.
You just don't find that many Mildreds
anymore.
No,
that's what I was about to say. Kids just, you know, young kids are not
there's
being
some of the names
Mildred.
That are making their way back, but
Esther? How about Esther? I saw a young Esther.
Through. Yeah, Esther might make it. Emma's huge, and that was, you know...
The Harry Potter films probably
the British,
took that one off.
Yeah,
right?
The British never let that go.
Who was in Emma? What?
Emma Watson. She was the female protagonist.
But she's indicative of the... No, she's the actress that is the female...
Right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, the characters, it got this name that's useless.
That's right. Titling, let's see. So they wrote it for the kindergarten students, titling it Good Morning to All. That was the original... lyrics. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning, dear children. Good morning to all. Patty later said.
I remember that.
Yeah, we sang that.
Yeah,
I didn't realize it was the
that
same
as a kid.
Song.
Same song.
I forgot
and I apologize
about that.
To everybody who's named their daughter Hermione. I'm really sorry. I know it's important to you, and I forgive me.
855 450 free. You can join us here. Have you ever been targeted for singing Happy Birthday? It's Free Talk Live.
Get the stinky dog away from me.
Petey stopped eating. All his hair fell out.
Mounds and mounds of fur.
Our hairballs have hairballs.
Bad breath and bad gas.
Chew himself raw. Sticky, gooey, smelly.
She scratched incessantly.
At least $5,000 in vet bills.
And all it took was one container of Dinovite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Adding Dinovite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
The shedding has stopped and the itching has stopped.
Tons of energy, no more bad smell.
She has gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen.
Everything we tried failed except the Dinovite.
My vet was completely blown away.
Dinovite's the bomb.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
No!
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you are a bar owner or restaurateur who has had trouble with the BMI ASCAP folks, the record company labels for singing happy birthday.
I wonder how involved they were, because they're the ones that sort of manage the enforcement.
They're
the
snitches. They send the agents around to the various different restaurants, and when they hear music, they write it down, and then they come after the restaurateur, and they threaten them.
Right. What's crazy is that you can buy a CD, and you can't play that CD in your business.
Yeah.
Now, we did this when I was a kid. I worked at a comic book store. From the time I was 12 years old to the time I was 18, I had a job at a comic book store, and we would play all kinds of music there. If we didn't have the radio on, and sometimes this is in Tampa Bay, you know, sometimes we'd be listening for contests or whatever. They had the Tukey Bird. Tukey, Tukey. When you heard that, you'd call in. Be the seventh caller in. And, of course, it's all rigged because they'd always answer calls from Tampa or St. Pete and never from Bradenton. But anyway, they had a local line and it wouldn't mix them up. So
much drama.
Yeah. Nonetheless, we would play the, you know, tapes and stuff. I remember playing Yaz and a variety of others. We had Styx and a few others that we would play in the store. And, you know, that was illegal. Now, I don't think we ever had an ASCAP BMI agent come through, but It was illegal. And if they did, maybe they came on a day that we were playing the radio. Fortunately, we played Vivaldi sometime, and that was probably completely legal.
Yeah, I don't imagine comic book stores are in their regular route.
Probably not, but pretty much all businesses play something.
A lot of them do, yeah. Of course, now, a lot of businesses play the radio, which you can do that, because the radio station...
It's satellite radio, too, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I had a friend who had...
This is not legal advice.
Right. I had a friend who had, back in 2006, was streaming for... he put a channel up on iTunes Radio. Mm-hmm. It was one of the first, and he was playing, like, top 40 hits, and he did that for 2 years before...
Somebody caught him.
They started mailing him letters. But at the time, it was still fresh on the internet, and they didn't know what the heck to do.
Yeah.
Was it radio or was it not? And, of course, they're going to lean towards getting money.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting. Pandora pays more for you to play... hear a song than, say, a radio station does.
Mm.
And what Pandora did was buy a radio station. It's been going through the courts. Basically, they want to be able to say that they're a radio station, so they can pay the lower price. But I think what's really wrong there is that the radio station, even if they stream online, is playing the same thing for everybody. So if I tune into Q100
right.
stream, and you tune in and you tune in, Taryn, we hear the same stuff. However, if you tune into Pandora and I tune in Pandora and you tune into Pandora, we all hear different stuff. So I'm not sure that that's going to work out for them.
Yeah, it's an interesting approach.
Unless they own thousands of radio stations.
Could be. Well, I can tell you, just like radio stations, there's contests. Well, I can tell you there's a contest on the internet. You could win $1,000 in Bitcoin just for typing something up. If you have the most appreciated post at forum.bitcoin.com, now this is not Free Talk Live's contest. This is forum.bitcoin.com's contest, but we're talking about it here. So it has to be appreciated, meaning people like the post or whatever, by January the 1st or when they get 10,000 users, whichever is first, then you win it. It's that simple. You go create an account right now at forum.bitcoin.com, and you tell your friends so that we can get to 1,000 users faster. forum.bitcoin.com.
Bitcoin.com, by the way, a great site, good intro site. So if you want to point somebody to a great intro to Bitcoin, bitcoin.com. It's an easy URL to remember. It's really the best page for that. And so they just launched this forum. And maybe we should have the forum owner on to talk about it at some point, because there's got to be a reason behind this forum.
I'm curious.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to launch a forum in this day and age, and so this is an interesting incentive to get somebody to go and sign up and post. $1,000 worth of Bitcoin over at forum.bitcoin.com for the most appreciated post, and by that, I think they mean that usually there's like a little appreciate button.
Yeah, it's like a like button, I would guess.
Yeah. So, there you go. Let's go to Mike in Clackamas, Oregon, and we'll talk more about Happy Birthday here in a moment. The copyright being overturned by federal court. Mike, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Taryn, and Mark.
Hey, guys. Can you hear me okay? My phone cut out last week, and that's why my phone calls dropped. Can you hear me okay now?
Yeah, sound great. Go ahead.
Awesome. Okay. So I originally wanted to continue my story about what happened. I had a run-in with, and this has to do with the open carry press release that Brad and Tommy were doing back in 2011 up on Plymouth State University campus. I originally wanted to go to this, but I had to work that day, so I couldn't. Well, back in 2013, I had a run-in with, which was a former sheriff, Grafton County Sheriff's Department sheriff. If you go to one of Pete Ayer's videos, he was taping a campus police officer and a sheriff up on campus, and the sheriff was the guy in the brown. He was a taller guy. Well, he's no longer sheriff. He is now one of the liquor enforcement officers in New Hampshire. So I was working at a bar in downtown back in 2013, and I recognized the sheriff, this former sheriff. He's now one of the liquor cops.
Was he working like an undercover liquor cop or obvious liquor cop?
No, he was obvious. He had a light blue polo on with a sewn-on badge.
Got it.
So anyways, he comes over to me, and I say, hey, how's it going? And I said, hey, I recognize you. And he says, you do? I says, I saw you on YouTube. He says, you did? I says, yeah, I says, you were one of the sheriffs that was attending the open carry demonstration up on Plymouth State University campus. He says, oh, yeah, I remember that back a few years ago. I says, what are your thoughts on being able to carry a firearm up on the campus? And here's what he said. He said, in his opinion, he thinks it would deter crime and rape and all these violent attacks. He says, as far as the open carry, he says, that tends to kind of cause some alarm. But he says, as far as concealed carry, he says, he's all for being able to carry a firearm and protect yourself.
He thinks it'd be a fine idea, but he would have arrested the protesters had they shown up with guns open carry.
That's his job, right?
Yeah, exactly. And this goes to show you how dangerous these, the following orders is, because something that, state law says you're allowed to do, but yet because this judge, which is technically legislating from the bench here, saying you're not allowed to do something, he's now following the orders of a judge, which you're supposedly allowed to do under state law and as well as, the Constitution, too. It was a brief, conversation.
Now, you're referring to the situation where a judge basically sent out an injunction against our friends who were going to do an open carry protest on the campus, essentially barring them from open carrying, meaning that if they did the open carry onto the campus, which is illegal, that they wouldn't have just gotten arrested for open carry. They would have been arrested for contempt of court. So he essentially short-circuited the protest. And thanks for sharing that story tonight, Mike. I appreciate hearing from you. Thanks for bothering to call back with it. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can actually see video of that particular protest if you watch Derek Jay's Victimless Crime Spree. And you can do that at victimlesscrimespree.com. There's more. You can join us at 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is up $7 at $1,132 per ounce. Silver is 11 cents higher at $14.93 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $230. Robertson Roberts is your trusted source for physical precious metals for nearly 40 years. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A-plus by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime, 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Talk Live here. You can join us toll free, 855-450-FREE. Bring up anything that happens to be on your mind, 855-450-3733. Hey, we've also got Skype. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Taryn P. Lupo.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can join us online. Go get interactive at freetalklive.com. You get to control the content right there on the front page of the website. You submit content to it, and then other listeners can vote it up or vote it down. You get to vote as well over at freetalklive.com. We will take that into account when we're deciding what to talk about on the radio waves. Coming up October 29th and 30th, we're talking about 5 weeks away at this point. You can join our very own Mark Edge.
Yep.
He's going to be with Stephanie Murphy and Trace Mayer and Tone Vase and Paul Pooey and Joseph von Perling, Bitcoin Bell, and more at the upcoming first ever Bitcoin Investor Conference. It's happening at the beautiful D Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. And you can get your early bird tickets right now at BitcoinInvestor.com. It's the first one ever of the Bitcoin Investor Conferences. And I think it's important to go to these first year events. First of all, because, you know, you want there to be a second year event. But also, when there is a second year event and you attend that one, everybody already knows who you are.
Yeah, you're the old pro.
Right. So it's great to be on the ground floor of an event like this. And it's in Vegas. So really, there's no reason not to do this. BitcoinInvestor.com. Go and check it out. And by the way, the D Hotel does take Bitcoin. That's BitcoinInvestor.com, October 29th and 30th. So we invite you to join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE, whether it's open carry or happy birthday or open carrying while singing happy birthday. We will talk about it here on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, just to get back to that open carry thing, the caller called in and he was talking to a police officer who had been at an event where basically it was a protest to advocate for college students to be able to carry guns on college campuses.
Which they can't do pretty much everywhere.
Yeah, pretty much all over the country. Might be a few, but I don't know the specifics, but it's pretty unusual.
Is there a law now that allows them? Is there a constitutional carry that allows on campus or not? Because I knew they were trying to push that through, and
that
I never thought that would happen.
Allowed. At least certainly not in New Hampshire. And New Hampshire is one of the more gun-friendly places in the United States. So I don't know if Vermont or Alaska, which are, I think, two of the better, more gun-friendly states.
You know, I've heard of a place that was doing it, but I don't remember where it was. Colorado comes to mind, but that doesn't mean anything. Honestly, it's safe to say that very few places you're going to be able to carry a gun on campus.
Thank you, Internet. Here is a website, armedcampuses.org, that says there are approximately 10 states that do allow this. Arkansas, Colorado, Idaho, Kansas, Mississippi, Oregon, Texas, Utah, Wisconsin. Now, does that mean that all the schools within those states are allowing it? I'm not
probably
so sure
not.
About that.
Well, I feel like when they were trying to pull the constitutional carries all over the states, that it included, like, you could carry it at government buildings, you could carry it on campuses. They went for everything, and I don't know how many of those passed and how many didn't.
It says here that these several states that I just mentioned have been forced in different ways to allow the carrying of firearms on their premises, such as campus grounds, classrooms, dormitories, or parking lots. So your mileage may vary as far as what is allowed and what is not.
But anyway,
I would check with the individual school.
The police officer in this circumstance who was going to enforce the rule that this was a judge's order, this wasn't even a law, really, or maybe it wasn't a constitutional law, regardless of what it is, enforce the judge's injunction, was in favor of college students being able to protect themselves on campus, but nonetheless would have enforced this law. And it's difficult for me to think of these gun ban situations as anything but victim disarmament laws. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm not sure that there's as many rapes on college campuses as we're told these days, but that doesn't really make a difference. What I can tell you is certainly there are rapes on college campuses. There's all kinds of violence that goes on college campuses, and that guns are an incredible equalizer. There's the old saying that God made man, but Sam Colt made him equal. And that means that, well, you know, a little girl who weighs 90 pounds can defend herself from the biggest, roughest, toughest masher that might be out there. And that's, you know, that's a good thing. We want that kind of equality to be in place. And
I think so.
Yeah. I mean, these are just laws that disarm these people. Yes, guns are used in suicides. That's a lot of the numbers. When you look at gun violence numbers, those are a lot of the numbers you're talking about are suicides. They should remove those completely because, well, frankly, people should be able to kill themselves if they want to. That's their decision. But they can do it in other ways if they wish to. Also, there's accidents. If you have a gun, you're liable to have an accident, and it's liable to hurt you, and it could kill you or a family member. There's no doubt about it.
Here's a hint. Don't point the gun at anything you don't want to destroy.
Those are good. That's a good piece of advice, certainly.
That will definitely reduce the amount of deadly accidents if it is never pointed at anyone. The story began, let's switch gears back, though, to the happy birthday story we opened the show with here tonight.
Sure.
We had just barely scratched the surface on the history of this. Now, there's a federal judge, for those of you just tuning in, who had ruled yesterday that it is no longer valid to collect royalties for the use of happy birthday. That's my understanding. We'll get a little more legal analysis on exactly what the ruling was here in a moment from the LA Times, which, by the way, the LA Times has now implemented what appears to be the newest thing in paywalls. You know how these newspapers are putting paywalls up all around the country?
Sure.
In that, well, you can only have 10 articles per month or whatever. Well, LA Times,
explain to me what a paywall is. I don't think I'm familiar with that concept.
That's basically where the newspaper will tell you, oh, well, you can have a free article today, but if you exceed a certain arbitrary number of free articles, we will not allow you to read anything anymore until you pay up. So
wow.
The paywall encourages, the idea is going to encourage you as a free writer,
frequent consumer,
to pony up and give them some money for news that is usually something you can find somewhere else. Most of the news stories carried by these newspapers, a lot of them are AP or Reuters, and you can go and find those at any other manner of sources with a quick Google search on the topic. So it's not hard, and a lot of these paywalls, it's not hard to traverse.
That, and I'm surprised in this day and age that newspapers are still charging people to read them, like online.
This is news to you?
No, I knew the Wall Street Journal did. Yep. I thought maybe like one or two big players, but
no,
I didn't think.
Lots of them.
I haven't read newspapers anymore. I get all my news, you know, with social networking.
So there are ways to get around a lot of these paywalls. Some of them, if you do the, the incognito or the private browsing window, you can just basically reset the counter. So whenever you go to one of these sites, if you've hit your 10 per month or whatever, just open up a private browsing window, go back to the site. And then they don't know who you are, so they start you at 10 again. So that's an easy way to get around it. Also, sometimes their mobile sites don't have the same restrictions. But the LA Times is now only allowing 5 per month. And it's my understanding that the local newspaper here in Keene, New Hampshire, has also reduced from 10 per month to 5 per month.
Oh, really?
So as though somebody who isn't willing to pay above 10 per month is all of a sudden going to be willing to pay over 5. I mean, it's just, I don't think that's going to increase the number of subscriptions they
have
at all.
It's also annoying. I pay for the newspaper here in town, mm-hmm. but I don't want to go through the process of
logging in
and doing all the
you
things.
You never know your own password.
Yeah. I mean, it's just...
I've asked Mark for his password a few times, and it's just... He's got to go ask his wife for it.
I don't know. I can, because I know that I can go to the incognito window. Yeah. It's just easier than getting up.
So anyway, here I am on the LA Times story with my first of 5 per month. The history of this happy birthday. Warner Music Group is the copyright holder. And they, by the way, are pulling down as much as 6 figures for licensing the use of Happy Birthday. So we'll talk about the history of the song here. Turns out it actually wasn't originally written as Happy Birthday. The song originally, in 1893, was written by a couple school teachers for kindergarten students, and it was entitled Good Morning to You. You may have heard that version of the song and didn't even realize that that's the original Happy Birthday. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number, 855-450-3733. Whether you want to talk about copyright or whatever, it's Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Now is the time to save on hardwood and more at Lumber Liquidators' end of summer clearance sale. We're making room for new fall inventory. That means it's your chance to get an incredible deal on solid pre-finished hardwood for just 99 cents. 3/4-inch solid pre-finished maple for $1.99, plus $1 off Bellawood Brazilian cherry and Koa hardwood. Get 10 to 15% off all Morningstar bamboo. American and European laminate from 49 cents and 24-month special financing. Hurry, the end of summer clearance sale is going on now. Visit lumberliquidators.com to find a store near you.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Wait a minute. Don't spend a dime on emergency food storage until you visit ReadySupplyFoods.com. If you're interested in getting the most high-quality food for your money, then see our comparison page where we list all the companies and rank them by value for your dollar. You'll see that Ready Supply Foods sells 50% more food for your money than any other company. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. Make an informed decision by going to ReadySupplyFood.com today.
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to may be even more nervous than you are. And the way things are now, your references have never been more important. Here are 3 tips. First, know that employers are checking. Every hire is under the microscope these days. Second, they won't just be checking references you provide. Figure that all of your ex-employers will get a call and be asked, would you hire him or her again? Third, assume you will be Googled. So before you apply, remove all those party animal photos from your Facebook page. Even if you're not in the job market, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Yeah, Free Talk Live, toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you're invited to join us here on the radio. You can also join us online at freetalklive.com. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, one of the ways you can do that is through the AMP program. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And that means that we are putting the show out there to new radio stations all the time, looking to get more listeners hearing the ideas of freedom on a nightly basis. And you can help us with that. For $5 a month, you get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast, as well as the fancy AMP-only Facebook group, which a lot of people use on a regular basis. It's probably way busier than our AMP forum ever was.
I just posted a picture of myself riding one of my pigs.
Wait, didn't you post those like a week ago? How's this one different?
Well, this one I've got my feet pulled up.
So this is a legit riding.
Standing astride a pig. Well, it took a little bit of training, but I got my motivation from saying that I'd get a picture.
You told me she's in heat. And then it was super easy to do.
Hey, why are you ruining this story?
Because it's a better story when you find out that the pig's in heat and it was waiting for Mark to mount it, which is why he was able to easily crawl up on her.
Well, what happens is that you can, when they're in heat, you push down on their rear haunches.
Yeah.
And this is how the guys do the artificial insemination. I'm not doing that, but you just kind of push on it and then the pig's just waiting for things to happen after that. actually, it was pretty easy.
You told me off the air that the pig...
That's good dating advice, too.
You told me off the air that these pigs, these females that are like 400 pounds or whatever...
Yeah, they're 450.
They know when you're around. Like, your wife will go into the pen to feed them or whatever, and they don't care about her.
No, she's
but when
no
you show up, then they get all randy.
Yeah, it's,
gave it to us in British.
Indeed, they do. There's no doubt that I'm convinced they can smell a male. And pigs, their sniffers are as good as dogs, at least in the short distance. I wouldn't use one as necessarily a bloodhound, but when you get close to something, they can smell just as well. And yeah, I think that's what they can do is that they can tell the difference between our genders. Which, you know, why would they be able to do that?
It's the magic of pheromones,
yeah,
I guess.
I think that's what it is.
Mm-hmm. I think pigs are, you know, I mean, they're really close to humans. That's why there's so much anatomy.
That's true.
And, you know, you can get a kidney from a pig.
And don't pigs have sex for pleasure? Aren't they one of the few animals, dolphins, pigs, humans
monkeys.
Who have sex for pleasure? Yeah, monkeys who have sex for pleasure.
Well, the girls don't do it outside of their cycle, but they do it a lot inside of their cycle.
Interesting.
From what I've been able to tell, the girls are pushier when it comes to sex than the boys are.
Mm-hmm.
So we had a boar who was on the property last year for a time. He was still growing up. I didn't realize, sure enough, he got mature pretty quick. And, you know, there he is doing his sister. And so I separate him into another pen. And it was my sow, Kelly Ayotte, that tore into the pen to get him rather than him tearing out to get to her. She just destroyed it.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. If you want to join us here, 855-450-3733. So we were talking about Happy Birthday. The song that was originally written, the music to it, was written in 1893. But at that time, it was titled Good Morning to All. And it was written by a couple of kindergarten teachers. Patty Smith Hill, one of the original writers, had later said she had worked with her sister to compose a simple melody to match the words that could be easily sung by young children. The sisters published the song in a book called Song Stories for the Kindergarten and assigned the copyright to their publisher, Clayton F. Sumney, Summy Corporation, in exchange for a cut of the sales. That was only the beginning of the tangled web of copyright law that various attorneys have argued may or may not apply to one of the world's most famous songs. Warner and the plaintiffs, that's Warner's the current copyright holder.
Is this like Warner Brothers?
That's right, Warner Music.
So this is the little guy fighting for his intellectual property, right?
Warner and the plaintiffs both agreed that the melody of the familiar song first written as Good Morning to All had entered the public domain decades ago, but Warner claimed it still owned the rights to the Happy Birthday lyrics, leaning on the 1935 copyright claim. At various turns in the case, attorneys argued over whether the Hill sisters had actually written the song, whether they had abandoned their rights to what became Happy Birthday's tune, and even whether Patti Smith Hill had been accurately quoted in a 1935 Time magazine article about the song. It's not entirely clear, the judge ruled, that the Hill sisters even wrote the lyrics for Happy Birthday to You. But either way, they never asserted a copyright claim for the lyrics, even though they sued for the rights to the original melody.
And the melody certainly was theirs, right?
Yes. Ultimately, the judge ruled that no evidence existed that the Summy Corporation, the original company to assert a copyright claim, ever legally obtained the rights to the Happy Birthday to You song from whomever wrote it. Tuesday's ruling means the song is now considered a public work and is free for everyone to use without fear of having to pay for it, according to a statement from the plaintiff's attorneys. That's big news for a lot of people who have been harassed and threatened for decades over the use of this song in various different circumstances. Jennifer Nelson.
It's certainly big news and in that sense, but it also kind of begs the question as to when a song, because this is an old song. When was this thing written?
1893. But the lyrics of Happy Birthday, so that was for the music. Lyrics, we don't know.
A date. This is...
Let's say at least 100 years ago or 80
years. It's 100 years old, and how long should a song sort of be copyrightable? Drugs are 17 years for the patent on
them. I say no time. I think there should be no copyright.
But I can see why people say, hey, if a big company gets a hold of some little guy's song and they make $1 billion on it, then they should cut the little guy in for some money. I get why people say that. Mm-hmm. I feel similarly.
They probably should do that. Well, but the other side of that coin, Mark, is that when a big song is written by a big company or whatever, and their producers, and because a lot of these artists in pop music don't write their own lyrics, right? So Rihanna or whoever,
right? It's just a big conglomeration of who writes things and produces them.
So the reverse of the scenario you presented is when these big mega corporations write a song and then you perform it as a local cover band or something like that, they'll come after your butt, right?
Yeah.
So it works both ways.
And what's crazy is some of these songs. I remember when Nina Paley made that cartoon online about the Indians. She was using some jazz singer from the 1920s, and somehow they were able to pull some magic trick that even though the song was in 1920, they renewed it and got a new copyright for another 50 years or something.
Oh, man.
And she had to pay a bunch of money. And I mean, it's like if you have enough money, you can just buy more copyrights, I guess. I don't know.
I don't know how that works. I don't know how the renewal thing goes.
Dirty.
I thought there was a certain arbitrary number of years.
Well, it used to be
over.
The artist's life, and at some point, the artist's life in 99 years. And this is a long stretch. It may very well be that Happy Birthday would still be copyrighted in this time frame if that's the if those are the numbers we're talking about. But why 99 years?
It's arbitrary number some politician pulled out of his butt.
I believe that was Cher's ex-husband, Sonny Bono.
Oh, really?
And, you know, why that number? What about Mozart? I mean, he's just one of the greatest composers of all time. Why is this guy's stuff in the this is the reason that Baby Einstein uses Mozart's music during their videos that babysit your kid for you.
Oh, it's
because it's free.
And I'm dealing with this all the time on YouTube. I make a significant amount of my income on YouTube, and you got to deal with all these nonsense copyright music laws. Like, I have to use pretty much super old music, or if you use the public domain music, everybody else uses it. So, mm-hmm. you know, it kind of, it's like, oh man, I've heard this before in the background of every other video. So it's a real pain to get around that. Even if I want to, like, I can play the trumpet, and even if I want to play my own version of it, I still, you know, I'm going to get flagged by YouTube and taken down probably.
Probably not as easily. I mean, their algorithm is looking for very specific waveform that matches the actual copyrighted recording in a lot of cases. So you probably would get away with your own rendition unless somebody flagged it and then they took a look at it.
Yeah, there's a bunch of narcs all over YouTube that want to do that and flag you for it.
But the argument, one of the arguments about, you know, restricting copyright is that, well, you know, people will be more creative if they can't use other people's works, but that's not necessarily true. Sometimes works that are derivative of an original work can also be very, very creative. And if people
Let's look at Ice Baby. I think this is a really great example. Now, you can say whatever you want to say about Vanilla Ice. That's fine. Ice Baby was a huge hit. It was a great song, and it took one of Queen's lesser hits and, you know, took that bass line from it, and it was ever so slightly different, but close enough to be the same thing, and it blew it up. What's wrong with that?
855-450-FREE. Maybe you can tell us what's wrong with it. 855-450-3733.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, September 23rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.83 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,130 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $232.
Antiwar.com reports Syrian warplanes have carried out one of their most intense series of airstrikes in weeks against the ancient city of Palmyra on the outskirts of the strategically important central city of Tadmur, killing at least 38 fighters from the Islamic State. The attacks continued for hours. The Islamic State captured Palmyra and Tadmur back in May, and while most of the focus has been on the danger the Islamic State poses to the antiquities in Palmyra, the capture of the area has given them a corridor through which to attack deeper west and deeper south into the country. The latest round of airstrikes likely reflects Syria's military growing emboldened by the receipt of new warplanes from Russia, allowing them more freedom to carry out airstrikes than they'd previously been able to with the remnants of their air force. Syria has lost some of its most important air bases in recent weeks, but Russian specialists along the Latakian coast have been expanding the airfields there, with the Syrian military mostly losing conflicts on the ground. Relying on air power is becoming one of the few ways they can stop the Islamic State at bay. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Martin Shkreli, CEO of Turing Pharmaceuticals, has defended the 5,000% price increase of the drug Daraprim, often used to treat toxoplasmosis in people with compromised immune systems like AIDS patients. In August, Turing Pharmaceuticals acquired Daraprim, which was first developed in 1953, and the company immediately increased the price of the drug from $13.50 per pill to $750 per pill. The price increase raised the average treatment costs for patients from about $1,130 a year to $63,000. Certain patients may need to pay up to $634,000 each year for Daraprim treatments. Daraprim treats toxoplasmosis, an infection caused by the Toxoplasma gondii parasite, one of the world's most common parasites. Although toxoplasmosis is not considered dangerous in people who are generally healthy, for people who are pregnant or have a weakened immune system, the effect of the infection can be severe. CBS News correspondent Don Dollar asked Shkreli, "Why is it necessary to raise the price of Daraprim so drastically?" Shkreli responded, "Well, it depends on how you define so drastically. Because the drug was unprofitable at the former price, so any company selling it would be losing money. And at this price, it's a reasonable profit, not excessive at all." The price of Daraprim was about $1 per pill several years ago before it was acquired by Core Pharma. Shkreli added, "This isn't the greedy drug company trying to gouge patients. It is us trying to stay in business."
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports plans to avert a U.S. government shutdown began taking shape in the Senate on Tuesday, but it was still far from certain whether a dispute over funding for women's healthcare group Planned Parenthood could be overcome. With only days remaining before an October 1st deadline, Senate leaders said they were pursuing a stopgap funding bill to extend the present federal budget for about 10 weeks beyond the September 30th end of the fiscal year. Senior senators from both parties said a continuing resolution was gaining traction. The Senate's continuing resolution approach may fail if conservative Republicans in the House of Representatives stand by their threat to oppose any spending plan that preserves federal funding for Planned Parenthood. President Obama and congressional Democrats oppose defunding the group, which has said it has done nothing wrong and blasted the allegations as deceptive and unfair. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. A report released this week by the Brookings Institution found that the U.S. currently has enough chairs and that there is no urgent need to produce any new ones for the time being. Researchers confirmed through overwhelming evidence that there is absolutely no shortage of chairs, citing in their findings the sheer number of armchairs, folding chairs, bar stools, Adirondack chairs, swivel chairs, lazy boys, and rocking chairs already in existence.
Our research shows that even in a place where there seems not to be enough chairs, a quick investigation will find one or two chairs just over in the next room. Basically, as far as chairs go, I'd like to reiterate that we have a very good number of them and could just use those.
And in this week's local news, shit, the guy in front of you is ordering for an entire construction crew. In other news, a local police department reduces costs by using the same evidence for every investigation. Voters are clamoring to hear if a female political candidate is a mother first, and a whitewater rafting trip in which a friend drowned is still pretty fun.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and we're launching into the second hour of the program. Of course, you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Happy birthday, now legal, according to a federal judge.
Oh, thank God.
In, I believe, Los Angeles. The LA Times reporting on this story. We were getting into some of the history of the Happy Birthday song written back in the 1890s, 1893, but it wasn't originally written as Happy Birthday. It was written as Good Morning to All. And then at some point, someone wrote the lyrics to Happy Birthday. But according to the case, nobody really knows who that was, even though there's a company that has been asserting the rights to the song for quite a while. Warner Music had purchased it from a company a little while back, actually a couple few decades ago, and have been actively enforcing their copyright, or at least what they thought was their copyright on this song, extracting hundreds of thousands of dollars, up to hundreds of thousands of dollars, from various different people who are using the song in movies and other music and restaurants, etc. So I want to continue that discussion, but joining you in the studio here tonight, it's Ian.
Taryn.
Oops, sorry, Taryn. Oh, try that again.
There we go. I'm Taryn P. Lupo, and I am on Periscope if you want to join us. See it behind
Twitter. Twitter.com/TarynLupo.
Yep.
And who are you?
And sir? Mark. I'm sorry. I was listening to the Periscope thing.
There you go. Yeah, I forget to mention that we have live streaming behind the scenes if you want to see what goes on at breaks on the Periscope feed.
Yeah, thank you for doing that, Taryn. It's an interesting addition to the show. Mark was telling all kinds of pig stories.
I gotta say, it's one of my favorite things to talk about.
He does get excited. You should see all the hand movements.
It is funny. It's really funny, too. You know, watching Mark over the decade plus that I've known him go from a convertible driving metrosexual in Sarasota, Florida, to a pig farmer in New Hampshire who lives in the woods.
Speaking of which, I have to do my nails.
So
not completely not metro.
So anyway, we were discussing Happy Birthday, but also copyright as a whole and the idea of it. And somebody, I think the question at the end of the last hour was something to the effect of, you know, can anybody tell us why copyright should exist? Because it restricts creativity. Some would argue that it forces people to be more creative. Like, for instance, you could claim that the restaurants who could not sing Happy Birthday, who wanted to wish a happy birthday to their clients, had to come up with something else. They had to be more creative in that way.
I think the argument I hear the most is that it allows people who are the first in on something to at least gain back their investment. You know, they did research and development to come out with a new product. That's the idea, because usually the second company that comes in is the one that really
patents,
earns.
Not copyright.
Copyright, right? Patents. Sorry, I lump them together.
I think they should both go away.
Intellectual property. Yeah. There's three types of intellectual property. There are patents, there's trademarks, and there's copyrights. And they have different aspects, but they're all intellectual property. And I can see a trademark as being an issue of sort of fraud. So if I sell a brown bubbly liquid in a red and white can that says Coca-Cola across it, but it tastes like purple grape drink, right? Like it's something that's not Coke, mm-hmm. but I sell it as Coke. Then I'm committing fraud essentially against everybody who's buying this stuff because it, you know, it's Coke, they think, and then they get, plah, what is this? They're surprised.
Well, also, yep. If you wrote a song and someone else claims they wrote the song, that's also fraud, isn't it?
It would. I would say that's fraud, but are you defrauding the person that – what are the damages at that point?
Well, I guess if they're making money off of the claim that they wrote the song or a book, for instance, if you wrote a book and then I took the book's words and put my name on the front of it and then started selling it, the damages would, in theory, be the money that I made from selling the book that I represented to be mine, but in point of fact was not written by me.
I don't have any great solutions for, because I believe intellectual property exists because it exists in people's minds. People, like, for instance, if you go out and you start you know, singing somebody else's song and like it's your song, yeah, people are going to be like, that's just wrong. Or the big music company puts some big singer behind the song that you wrote and you were performing or whatever, and they don't give you any money. People are going to be like, that's wrong.
I think you can let the market handle this. I think that, you know, it's not a perfect world. There are going to be situations that are going to be less than desirable, I imagine, for folks who otherwise would want to rely on the government to protect them. But generally, you know, for instance, if you wrote the book originally and then I start shopping it around bookstores and turns out that you were the original writer of it, then hopefully the bookstores would have the, you know, the connections to the industry to be able to get their books from proper sources and not just some guy coming in off the street offering them to them.
I'll tell you how I handle this, because
you are an author.
Yeah, I've got almost 20 books on Amazon, and the way I handled this, because you can't put any book out there these days and expect that someone's not going to just torrent it and put it out somewhere for free. I mean, yeah, you can find my books free everywhere. The way I handled this is if someone were to be as brazen as to take my name off it and put their name on and sell my book, I turn the fans against them. So I say, hey, you know, you always have some superstar fans that love your work. And you say, hey, this guy is pretending to be me. Go destroy the reviews on Amazon. And so you send them, you tell the fans, and they're very protective over you because they know if you don't make any money, you're going to stop writing.
Right. And a store that is selling this competitor's book, the scammer, they're not going to be happy with customers coming to them telling them, hey, you've got the wrong book, right? They're going to make the change, and they're going to call you, and they're going to get the right book in there because they want to look like they're on the up and up. And they would say, whoa, it was an honest mistake. You know, we didn't know. And also think about this. The originator of the so-called intellectual property is always first to market. You know, nobody else knows what your book's going to say until you release the book. And so you at the very least have whatever time it takes between when you release the book and when somebody finally gets around to reverse engineering it or whatever you want to call it, right, and then putting their own name on it. So you are always first to market, and the market has come up with interesting ways to release books. Stephen King is one of the people who's done this, as far as I understand, is where releasing chapters at a time. So if you're really concerned about this, if you're really concerned about the idea of somebody taking your book and then doing something with it after you've released it, well, just release one chapter at a time until you get paid the amount that you're looking for the next chapter. Then you release that chapter. And then by the time the whole book is released, you know, you've had this long period where your fans are paying up to get to read whatever it is that happens next. And whoever it is that wants to rip off your book has to wait through the entire period to get through to the end of the book, right? So there are ways to kind of draw this out and use the market and creative means of release to put as much money in your pocket as possible.
There are some good ones. I've experimented with some myself because of this issue, but there are other issues that are tougher. Like, my girlfriend writes articles and makes money, and they pay for, you know, they have like Google AdSense on some of her more popular articles, and she gets paid, and she gets a victim of her own success. Like, it ends up being one of the best articles on the net. Everybody rips it off and posts the exact same article everywhere, and it bleeds a bunch of her traffic away, and she loses money. I don't know how to handle that necessarily when you're constantly, you know, your job now is to go chase down Russians who are stealing your articles and putting them out. Or
you should not make that your job.
No,
it's not worth it.
Distracting, but it does hurt. Her sales went way down. Like, her ad, they were siphoning off traffic, and Google punishes you if you write something original and then it appears somewhere else on the internet. They drop your rankings for that. You never want to put duplicate material on it because it destroys the rankings on your website. Yeah. Huh.
So that was destroying her website, the fact that people are swiping stuff?
Right. And I don't know how to handle that, being, you know, a liberty-minded guy that I don't deal with copyright, but, you know, I'm not going to go threaten some person.
It's just
we're going to have the government.
Business.
It's handle
just,
this.
That's just the cost of doing business. That's yeah, you know,
I guess
if you want to write
you
on
made
the internet,
money for a while, and then that's
yeah,
it.
It's
you
over.
Know, until everybody jumps on.
And that's one of the things that copyright does that's ridiculous, is it allows somebody who never wrote the original work to profit from granddaddy's efforts or whatever down the line 100 years later. And yeah, that's ridiculous.
That's yeah, the other end of this is that, you know, you,
trust
how
fund,
far does this go? And remember that Tharg, who created the wheel, and Urg, who figured out the fire, you know, these guys, if assuming they made it and assuming that we're still, you know, we're related to these guys, the you know, their technology moves our world in so many amazing ways, but it's not like everybody's getting paid for the fact that they're all related to these guys that made the wheel or whatever.
855-450-FREE. If you want to talk about intellectual property, you can join us here on Free Talk Live. That toll-free number, 855-450-3733, or Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Free Talk Live.
The Supreme Court has ruled over and over again that government has no obligation to provide any services, even services as remedial as protection. They don't have any obligation to provide those services. So therefore, if there is no obligation on their part to provide any services, why should there be an obligation on our part to pay them?
Well, there isn't. It's only an obligation they, you know, implement this thing, and then you're afraid because they have guns.
People are scared.
But it's never going to end until we get in over that fear.
Absolutely. I mean, we're essentially being terrorized by a group of gangsters calling themselves the U.S. federal government. The only difference between the federal government and, you know, a thug on the street is the size of the gang. It's time people start treating the IRS like the thugs they are.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
LRN.FM is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.FM in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. We've been talking about copyright and so-called intellectual property, patents, etc., which was all sparked by the Happy Birthday song being released into the public domain by a federal judge who determined basically that there is no copyright on Happy Birthday, and all of the claims that Warner Music has made over the years are basically invalid. So all the money they collected essentially without having any legal backing, but they pulled it off for close to three decades. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE if you want to join us here. Let's go to Tom. He's in Burbank, California, and you're listening online. Hello, Tom.
Hey there. Thanks for taking my call.
Sure. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, I just wanted to let you know that I found you from Periscope, so Periscope works.
Awesome.
That's awesome.
Yeah, exactly. Otherwise, I would not even have known you guys existed.
Thanks.
And so I was listening to you a little bit. And, yeah, I'm here in Burbank, home of Warner Music, Warner Brothers. And I've worked in the entertainment business. I've never worked on the music side. I have worked on the marketing side in for movies and television and home video and games. But when I hear you talking about copyrights, and I'm not really quite sure what the business model is if you got rid of copyrights. I mean, just because, and I was really interested in where you were taking the conversation about the blog posts. If your girlfriend writes the blog posts and spends her time and effort putting them out there, and someone else grabs it and makes money from it, I mean, what's the incentive, you know, to be doing that?
Well, I believe that she makes money by being the first to do it. It takes a little while for that to happen, but
right.
That is a frustrating option. But my issue is a moral issue. I'm not about to use the government and send the government's force to go make someone take that down. There's got to be a better way where I can live with myself morally and not use force on my neighbor to get them to do what I want.
Well, back before, we've had Dr. Mary Ruart on the show, the author of Healing Our World. She worked in the pharmaceutical industry in decades past, and she told us that before, you know, patents existed on medication, the incentive for Bayer or whoever it was to manufacture a medicine would be that if they were first to market, it'd be their name that people would remember, right? Like when you go, when somebody went to buy aspirin or whatever, they'd ask for Bayer or whoever it was that was first to market there. And so there's a lot of value in being the originator of whatever the idea happens to be, and the market will reward whoever it is that's first to market. So that's the incentive.
And there's also, I mean, there's industries you can look at. For instance, the only thing that's copyrightable, or you know, the only intellectual property in the fashion industry is the name brand. So
yeah, that's true. The design itself is not copyrighted.
The Gucci handbags, one of the reasons these handbags are covered in these gaudy, awful logos is that they can't copyright the cut and the material and these things that are used to make them. But somehow or another, the fashion industry manages to every single year sell us short skirts or long skirts or wide ties or thin ties, or, you know, this year's it's pastels is the palette or whatever it is that they do.
For very high dollars, too. Yeah, these brands are very expensive.
They don't seem to have any problem with that.
That's why Gucci puts their big G on everything, is because now that part's illegal to copy, but not the design of the bag.
Well, I mean, it's certainly in there.
Or the Coach. Coach puts their little CCs on all the fabric everywhere.
So does that answer some of your question there, Tom?
I don't think that, no, I don't quite agree, because I think what will happen, certainly in the entertainment world, is that people, I'm not sure I quite agree with your concept that people will reward whoever brought it in there first. people will reward whoever brings it to them cheapest. So if I go out there,
some people will. Not all.
Oh, I think a huge majority of people will, if it's legal. I mean, I think one of the things that kept a lot of people from, you know, downloading free music was because, you know, they honestly thought it wasn't the right thing to do.
That's ridiculous.
Now, you might be able to make it conflating what is right with what is legal is pretty dangerous. Throughout human history, we can look at a lot of wrong things that were done under the color of law and vice versa. But I do understand what you're saying is that people thought it was wrong. Is there a way that we can make it wrong without having the penalty that's associated with it? And I don't know the answer to that.
Yeah, I wish.
But I think what will happen. I think what will happen with entertainment content is people will go for, you know, wherever they can get it the cheapest. And if I could, you know, take a movie and create, you know, steal the content and put it on a DVD for $2.
But there's no evidence for that. There's no evidence for what you're saying.
Let me handle this, because this I did run into with writing books.
Mm-hmm.
Is, you know, you're in this day and age, there's no way your stuff's not going to get stolen. You're going to have to deal with that as a reality. No matter what musician you are, whatever movie you put out, there's just too many people, generations that have been brought up that are not afraid of it. They don't think it's illegal. I don't know anyone that's under 35 that pays for music, you know, unless
sure
it's
do,
like an artist
they
really like. Yeah,
or,
the
or
artist.
If it's an artist they really like. Look,
but other than that, man, it's a changing world that you're crazy to spend all your energy chasing this stuff around.
There have been studies done on the people who download torrents, the people who are downloading the music and the movies, the things that you're using the term stolen, Tom. And what they found out is that a lot of these folks, they're not in the marketplace to buy it in the first place. So, you know, just because they're downloading the movie doesn't mean they were a good prospect to go and pay $10 for the ticket to go and see it in the theaters. And these movies are still getting $100 million in a weekend, and they're still, you know, raking in the cash. So the claim that, you know, somebody sitting in the back of a movie theater with a video camera recording the movie is somehow a significant threat to these multi-billion dollar companies is pretty ridiculous. I mean, you can go right now, whatever the hot new movie is, and you can go on the torrent sites and you can find a version of that movie because somebody sat in the back of a theater and recorded it with their camera or set up a tripod or whatever. But that version of the movie sucks and nobody wants to watch that version of it. You know,
it sure isn't in real 3D.
It's definitely not in 3D. And so, you know, 3D and surround sound, these are things that the movie theaters can offer that the online experience doesn't offer. And so I don't know. I don't think there's any evidence for it. And they also found that a lot of people use the online downloading as ways to sample product.
Yeah.
So, you know, instead of having to buy a CD, you know, you talked about Vanilla Ice earlier. I don't know what his CD was like back in the 1990s, but let's just say there was only one or two good tracks on it. That wasn't atypical for music.
That's
right?
How it was back in the day.
They'd have the popular couple of radio hits, and the rest of the album was just kind of a throwaway. So, you know, people would buy, they'd paid $19 for the CD back then, and they'd be bummed out because they got a junk CD, but now they can sample it online. And if they like it, then they know, hey, look, if I don't buy this person's music, they're not going to make another album. People understand that. They're not stupid.
Well, I can only relate to you my own experience. And working in the home video world, which I completely agree with you on the, you know, going seeing in the movie theater versus the nasty video that someone took in the theater is not the same experience. That's not really.
I want to hear more about your home video experience. If you can hang on, Tom, we'll bring you back and discuss that with you if you've got the time for it. Guy works in the industry out in California, right where Warner is based, he says.
Burbank, sounds legit.
Yep, 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
on account. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Because you're scared of me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
SWCPoker.eu is Bitcoin Poker 2.0, where players can buy chips, play, and cash out anonymously with Bitcoin. No banking, just Bitcoin. Texas Hold'em, Omaha Hold'em, draw, and many new games, including Chinese poker. SWC Poker gladly accepts players worldwide, and over 2 million hands of Bitcoin poker have been dealt at SWCPoker.eu. Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust. SWCPoker.eu.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. The Skype username is lrn.fm. If you're online and you care about privacy, you need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network. They encrypt all of your online data before it gets to your internet service provider, and ProXPN does it right. They offer OpenVPN, which is the gold standard of network encryption. They've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and Linux support as well. So whatever operating system you're using, you can use ProXPN. And unlike those other guys, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever. They've got more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security, and they'll take credit card as well as Bitcoin. You can get 50% off their regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account, and when you buy your annual account, you can use code FTL50 to get that deep discount of 50% off the regular monthly price. It can be cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. ProXPN.com, code FTL50. Take back the privacy that is your right. As we go back to Tom, he's in Burbank listening to Free Talk Live for what sounds like the first time. He found us on Periscope thanks to Taryn, who has been broadcasting during a lot of the breaks. He's actually still doing it right now in the, the middle of the show as well. And so we've been discussing intellectual property. Tom, you work in the business, the movie and video industry.
Did I miss more of the pig stories?
That's what's happening on the Periscope.
I don't think there was a pig story during the break.
Yeah, not
during.
Because I was like, I couldn't do the Periscope and the phone at the same time.
Yeah, that makes sense.
No more pig stories.
So you said that, you know, we were talking about how in a world without intellectual property, or at least without the government protecting it and leaving it to the market to come up with more creative ways, more solutions that maybe we haven't thought of here, that having something come out to the marketplace first gives you a benefit over everybody who might copy it later on down the line. You gave the example of somebody who would rip a movie and put it on a DVD and then sell it for $2. And those people exist. They're on the streets of some big cities. You know, they open up their coat, they got DVDs hanging there. Yeah. Right? Hey, you want to piss? You want to DVD,
the other side
kid?
Of the coat has you know, Rolexes for $15 too.
So, so Tom, you were going to give us an example of why you don't think that would necessarily apply to the home video market as opposed to major release films.
Yeah, well, certainly on the home videos, I think one of the things, and you touched on it earlier, that the theater experience is something that can't be duplicated outside the theater. So that's something that no one else can do. But when it comes to the home video side of it, to have a movie on a piece of plastic. That, one of the things that I just noticed, certainly at Warner Brothers on the home video side, I mean, sales of DVDs, have really shrunk over the years. Part of that is because of streaming, but part of it is also because of people that were buying it and not paying Warner Brothers for it. And it's really true in all the home video operations. Here in town, it's been the same thing. So I know that certainly internally it was a big issue that did hurt sales. So I know a lot of people lost their jobs, just from downsizing and things like that, because sales just weren't where they once were.
Well, as you said, though, streaming's a factor too, right? So
I want to know how the home video market has adjusted. Like, what changes have you seen for them to adapt so they can survive?
Certainly the streaming. Well, one of the things, and you're talking about it, is the going after every legal avenue to maintain that kind of control, and that's certainly something that is always a big part of any entertainment business. And certainly the streaming, I think they like streaming because they're getting paid for it, from Netflix or from Amazon or whoever.
Yeah, but do they make as much off of a stream viewer as they would somebody buying a DVD?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Because they don't have to ship and put those things together. Yeah.
Well, no, but what I mean...
you're exactly right.
Okay, no, I understand that. So, I mean, out of a DVD, if you're looking at a $20 DVD, there's a certain amount of it that's going to the retailer, right? So there's a wholesale cost. So let's say it's a, $5, $10 wholesale cost or something like that. And then there's the wholesaler who's taking a cut. So certainly you are cutting out the middleman. What is it? I mean, what's a payout from Netflix per view of a movie? What's a realistic payout?
I mean, to be really honest, and I worked at Netflix too years ago.
Oh wow!
But not in this side of the business. I was on the marketing side of business. I worked at Netflix when it was a startup. Usually the deal is, and I have no inside information here, but typically the deal is a certain dollar amount that's paid for each episode of television or each movie, and then probably some kind of revenue share. Of each time it is streamed out there.
Do you know what the amount is? So there's like a licensing fee to where, let's say, Sharknado, I just saw that one recently, Sharknado gets licensed to be used by Netflix as a stream option, but then they also pay per view. So what's the pay per view? Is it like 5 cents, 50 cents, a buck? I mean, what are we talking about?
I honestly don't know, but... I mean, I'm not trying to, well, to hide anything
you
here.
You were certain that they're making more money off of streaming. Do you? I think what Ian's question was is, do they make
in total
off of a stream as they made off of a DVD, I think is what Ian's question was.
That's my question.
Because I'll bet you more people are watching more videos because they don't have to go out to the video store to watch, and I'd be willing to bet that. I've gotten rid of my television. So if I want to watch something, I'm going to have to watch it through Amazon Prime. It either needs to be – it's going to be streamed. It either needs to be paid for or not paid for. So, yeah, I'm watching things – I'm watching – my viewing habits have changed entirely in the last 5 years.
There's still a market out in the rural country where you just don't have streaming ability. Like, you just don't have, you know, you're on a satellite or something. So there's still DVD sales for that area. But honestly, with the streaming, my understanding is Netflix will either buy it outright where they pay one-time fee and they play it as much as they want for a certain period, or they'll do what he's talking about where they'll buy it and give you a little piece each time it plays. I doubt it's anything close to what a DVD.
I can't imagine it's more than 50 cents
no,
as far as
No, it's probably
per...
less than that. It's probably pennies, but they're getting probably hundreds of thousands of hits. I mean, being on Netflix is like
right,
the holy
exactly.
grail.
So do you know what the DVD profit? I mean, what's the average profit on a $20 DVD for Warner? I mean, what does that go for? Is it a buck?
Your numbers were about right that you were talking about there before. And again, it depends on
what I don't. What did I say?
50 cents.
50 cents for.
Oh, you were saying it was about, you know, about a 50% markup in the store. So yeah, if it's a $20 DVD, the store probably bought it for $10. And
but how much of that is plastic?
Big chunk of that $10.
But how much of that is plastic?
So, right, there's manufacturing costs as well. But I mean, like, you know, at the end of the day, if Warner sells one DVD, what does Warner take home out of that $20? Is it $5?
Probably $5 to $7 mm-hmm. would be my estimate. And again, it also that was one of the reasons that Blu-ray was so good, because Blu-ray was you know, you can make more margin on Blu-ray.
Well, yeah, they're like $40
brand
new.
High profit.
I don't think you can stream Blu-ray quality, right?
Yeah, they've got pretty high-end streaming these days, but it's still not quite, I don't think it's quite Blu-ray.
It was kind of a great marketing technique that you could only get these Blu-ray quality with a Blu-ray machine.
But what you're saying, Tom, just to be clear, is that now with streaming, with Netflix, the Amazon Primes and all that, you're saying the movie houses, the Warner Brothers, the Paramounts of the world, they're pulling in more revenue from streaming sales than they are from DVD sales.
Yes.
Interesting. So that's a good thing then.
Yeah, they are. It's
okay that DVDs are dying off. I mean, this is an old format, right? It's more than a decade. It's 2 decades old. DVD is 2 decades old. I remember they came out in like, what, 95, 96?
What's going to replace this? I want to know because, you know, here I am. I'm buying movies on Amazon and, you know, I'm afraid what's going to happen to my CDs or my DVDs is the same thing that's going to happen to my Amazon. In 20 years, this is going to go away. But I can't even imagine what's going to replace it.
Maybe super 3D TV or something. I mean, they're just going to upgrade it.
Tom,
I have no
welcome
idea.
To Free Talk Live. Thanks for listening tonight. And you can get us seven nights a week over at freetalklive.com anytime you want. And feel free to call us anytime. Thanks, man. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Maybe you got some comments on copyright, the movie business, how things have changed over time. Yeah, let's talk about what's next. It's Free Talk Live.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of Otupure, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-717-9859. The revolutionary Otupure design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with Otupure. Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
This is Sharon Hunt. Before using Heart and Body Extract, my energy level was very, very low. I could only walk a few feet and then would have to sit down. I was tired and lethargic. But after taking Heart and Body Extract, my energy level has improved greatly, and I can now walk longer distances without getting tired so fast. Thank you, Heart and Body Extract.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is up $7 at $1,132 per ounce. Silver is 11 cents higher at $14.93 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $230. Robertson Roberts is your trusted source for physical precious metals for nearly 40 years. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Yeah! Free Talk Live, inviting you to join the show here and get on the air, talk about whatever happens beyond your mind. We are discussing the issue of copyright, patents, intellectual property, sort of the wider issue. We started the discussion with the news that Happy Birthday is now legal. You can sing it in a business if you want to. It used to be illegal to do that. And a federal judge has overturned the copyright claims of the copyright holder, or who thought they were the copyright holder, Warner Brothers. Our toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Skype in at username lrn.fm. You can bring up what you want. And with you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Taryn P. Lupo.
And Mark.
The judge ultimately ruled that no evidence existed that the Summy Corporation, the original company to assert a copyright claim over Happy Birthday, ever legally obtained the rights to the Happy Birthday to You song from whomever wrote it. And nobody knows who that was. This is from the LA Times. Tuesday's ruling means the song is now considered a public work and is free for everyone to use without fear of having to pay for it, according to a statement from the plaintiff's attorneys. And this has brought us to a larger discussion about copyright in general. And Mark, you had just asked a moment ago, what's next? You know, we talked about the different formats of movies, for instance, like, you know, VHS and Beta, and then VHS won that war, and then DVD came out in the mid-1990s, and then in the aughts we had HD DVD and Blu-ray. Blu-ray won that war. But Blu-ray kind of came out at a time when streaming was just starting to really get rolling. And you could argue that streaming essentially kind of neutered the success of Blu-ray. It never really took off in any significant manner, from my understanding. I mean, I haven't looked at the numbers recently, but DVD still kind of going strong out there after two decades as the dominant format. A lot of people who aren't videophiles won't know the difference between Blu-ray and DVD. I mean, to me, it's obvious the difference. It's a huge difference in picture quality, but
well,
I'm a videophile.
When we buy movies online through Amazon at Amazon Prime, we always get the low quality. We've got one.
You don't
of these,
pay extra for the HD.
Right, another $5 or whatever for the HD. I frankly cannot tell the difference. Mm-hmm. I, you know, maybe it's the streaming.
Your TV can only project so much because
it's not like
I don't notice a big difference either when I was doing it.
I've got one of these flat things that we put up on the wall. I probably didn't pay the extra money to have the 1080 versus the 720 or whatever it is. That doesn't sound like me, but I mean, I thought it was a huge upgrade from this giant cabinet thing that I was using prior to that. I had like a 50 inch TV from 1995 that I replaced, and so
the question is, what's next after streaming? I don't know. It's hard to envision that. It certainly doesn't seem like it's going to be physical media.
I think I have an answer, maybe. Is, the cable industry, I guess I should say, is losing money hand over fist because everybody's canceling, I don't know.
Cord cutters, as they are called.
And I haven't had it in years. Mark has.
I never had cable television as an adult. I have cable modem for internet access, but that's it.
So what I think is going to happen is I think cable's finally going to have to give in and let people pick and choose and create their own packages so you can get like
a la carte,
the few channels you want. I think that's going to be the next thing that happens for them to compete. I don't see how.
Yeah, that's all they got left. I think you're right.
Yeah,
but
I mean, what else can they do?
Even that's just a last-ditch attempt, right?
Yeah,
like,
because
that's not real innovation.
I mean,
it's
nice. Like, I have all three. I have Hulu, Amazon, and Netflix. And we got to surf around to get the shows you want. Like, they're not all on one. Mm. You know, Netflix mainly has old shows. Amazon, you usually have to pay for
everything. See, I still do it old school. I still got the platters being sent to me. I get the discs coming from Netflix.
Yeah. I just suck about returning
those
things.
I wouldn't want to do that.
Well, I don't watch enough stuff. Like, I had Sharknado sitting on my shelf for 3 months.
You're the best customer ever.
Yeah, they love me, right? Because I don't actually return the disc in any amount of time. Like, I sit on it for 3 sets. Sharknado cost me $30 just to sit there and wait for me to actually watch the thing. Anyway.
I got no, I just want to get mine and get it now and listen to it. And I would never want to do that, go back to getting the DVD sent to me in the mail.
Yeah, I think you're probably in the majority there. What do you think? What's coming next after streaming? How could anything come next? I'm sure something will, but, we don't know what it is.
It's got to be better quality streaming is all I can think of.
Well, yeah, 4K is on the way. So 4K is like, a lot higher resolution than 1080p. But as you pointed out, Mark.
Or 3D or something.
There's a certain point of diminishing returns. Like, if you sit too far away from your TV set, you can't discern the difference between 720 and 1080. The human eye just can't discern that at a certain distance. And so the difference between 1080p and 4K, again, you're going to have huge displays to really maximize the 4K vision. So that's what's next, but how popular it's going to be in any amount of time, I don't know. Let's go to the phones and to the fun. Maybe sex robots are next. That's what Matthew's calling about.
Yeah.
Matthew, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello?
Hey, can you hear me?
Hey, yeah, go ahead.
Hey, one for what you were just talking about. I actually work for a Cox cable.
Oh, okay.
And it's like $70 to get any base TV package with any of what a lot of people call essential programs like ESPN or Cartoon Network or anything like that. So, yeah, they're really, really taking a beating on stuff like that. And
are there discussions at the corporate? I mean, I don't know what what job you have with them, but are there any talks about what Taryn was discussing, the a la carte option, allowing people to just take a few?
For a la carte, no. What they're trying to do to get people to do that is, offering huge, huge discounts, like, 60% savings if you order phone and internet, which phone is an antique and nobody wants anyway,
mm-hmm.
and you just get massive discounts, and then they waive like ridiculously overpriced installation fees. So, like, that's how cable companies are trying to combat it, is they're just you know, shifting away from the cable market and more into the internet market.
Then they are in trouble. And if they keep on, if that's their thing, is that they're going to keep on trying to figure out how to get that same amount out of the household as they used to, they're in trouble, because I am not spending anywhere near what I used to spend in dollars, not even real dollars, but just dollars, as I was 10 or 20 years ago.
I think realistically, I would pay the same as a Netflix subscription if I could pick maybe top 10 channels I wanted.
I'd be happy to. I'd love to watch some football.
Something cheap like that.
But you can go to a bar and watch that if you have.
Or you can get it through the air still. A lot of high def, you know, a lot of high def antennas is pretty decent.
You can't do that in Keene, New Hampshire. Go ahead, Matthew.
I've always thought that it'd be like in football or hockey's best interest that, you know, $100 you could buy a subscription to like just the Baltimore Ravens or just the Detroit Red Wings or something like that. Don't care about the other 31 teams or anything out there, but like, I know as a mild sports fan, like, I'm not diehard or anything. I wouldn't throw down the $300 or whatever it is for Sunday ticket, but for just one team, yeah, I'd be willing to throw down $100 for an entire season.
Now, Sunday ticket, is that a DirecTV thing or is that through their website?
That's just DirecTV.
Because I know that some of these national sports companies are offering web streaming of their product. Now, I don't know if it's where you can buy a one-team deal or you have to just get the whole thing, but I suspect it's the former. I suspect because you know, each team has their own site, and so I think that, you know, if you're like a what is it, Buccaneers or Boston Red Sox fan, that you can just go to the Boston Red Sox site and subscribe to that. I suspect. I don't know. I'm not a sports fan, but I believe that that's the case.
So then, but anyway, what I was actually calling in for, you know, I think it was last week you guys were talking about like cryogenically freezing people. And like,
I think Mark has a commercial about Mark.
We talked about it too.
Yeah, did you? Okay.
Okay. So, you know, they're working on trying to ban sex robots or anything before that's even a thing. Now, just hypothetically speaking, you know, somebody dies, they preserve their head. You know, 50 years from now, they can bring that person essentially back.
50? You know, that sounds optimistic.
Well, you know, however long.
Okay.
But, you know, Futurama style, throw the head on a robot body.
Yep.
Would that still be considered, you know, hypothetically speaking, a sex robot? Or would that essentially be that person again? Would that just be, you know, like you guys were comparing augmentation to, like, glasses and stuff?
Well, I think as long as it's got that person's personality and memories and all that, and you know, their soul, if you will, then people would see that as a person.
Yeah, because
and not,
I mean,
a robot.
If you think someone who had a stroke that can't move their body or do anything, they're still a person because
Stephen
their brains.
Stephen Hawking, for instance.
I mean, he could be. We could replace every one of his limbs with, you know.
Although, isn't Hawking
limbs.
One of the ones who's saying the robots, look out, the robots are going to kill everybody and take over? Isn't he
He's on the list.
Yeah.
Is he?
Hey, Matthew, thanks for the call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And I would like to know still, if anyone has an answer to Mark's question, what is coming next? I mean, obviously the 4K TV, that's just a higher resolution. That doesn't have to do with delivery systems, right? So is there something beyond streaming? I don't see what it would be, right? Like, we're all going to have more internet, more connectivity, and so streaming isn't going to go away. It doesn't seem like, but, you know, who knows? You can answer the question if you want or bring up anything on Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, September 23rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.83 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,130 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $232. Antiwar.com reports Syrian warplanes have carried out one of their most intense series of airstrikes in weeks against the ancient city of Palmyra on the outskirts of the strategically important central city of Tadmur, killing at least 38 fighters from the Islamic State. The attacks continued for hours. The Islamic State captured Palmyra and Tadmur back in May, and while most of the focus has been on the danger the Islamic State poses to the antiquities in Palmyra, the capture of the area has given them a corridor through which to attack deeper west and deeper south into the country. The latest round of airstrikes likely reflects Syria's military growing emboldened by the receipt of new warplanes from Russia, allowing them more freedom to carry out airstrikes than they'd previously been able to with the remnants of their air force. Syria has lost some of its most important air bases in recent weeks, but Russian specialists along the Latakian coast have been expanding the airfields there. With the Syrian military mostly losing conflicts on the ground, relying on air power is becoming one of the few ways they can stop the Islamic State at bay. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Martin Shkreli, CEO of Turing Pharmaceuticals, has defended the 5,000% price increase of the drug Daraprim, often used to treat toxoplasmosis in people with compromised immune systems like AIDS patients. In August, Turing Pharmaceuticals acquired Daraprim, which was first developed in 1953, and the company immediately increased the price of the drug from $13.50 per pill to $750 per pill. The price increase raised the average treatment costs for patients from about $1,130 a year to $63,000. Certain patients may need to pay up to $634,000 each year for Daraprim treatments. Daraprim treats toxoplasmosis, an infection caused by the Toxoplasma gondii parasite, one of the world's most common parasites. Although toxoplasmosis is not considered dangerous in people who are generally healthy, for people who are pregnant or have a weakened immune system, the effect of the infection can be severe. CBS News correspondent Don Dollar asked Shkreli, "Why is it necessary to raise the price of Daraprim so drastically?" Shkreli responded, "Well, it depends on how you define so drastically. Because the drug was unprofitable at the former price, so any company selling it would be losing money. And at this price, it's a reasonable profit, not excessive at all." The price of Daraprim was about $1 per pill several years ago before it was acquired by Cor Pharma. Shkreli added, "This isn't the greedy drug company trying to gouge patients. It is us trying to stay in business."
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports plans to avert a U.S. government shutdown began taking shape in the Senate on Tuesday, but it was still far from certain whether a dispute over funding for women's healthcare group Planned Parenthood could be overcome. With only days remaining before an October 1st deadline, Senate leaders said they were pursuing a stopgap funding bill to extend the present federal budget for about 10 weeks beyond the September 30th end of the fiscal year. Senior senators from both parties said a continuing resolution was gaining traction. The Senate's continuing resolution approach may fail if conservative Republicans in the House of Representatives stand by their threat to oppose any spending plan that preserves federal funding for Planned Parenthood. President Obama and congressional Democrats oppose defunding the group, which has said it has done nothing wrong and blasted the allegations as deceptive and unfair. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Officials for the Centers for Disease Contraction and Preservation held a press conference urging all Americans to suck on as many doorknobs as possible.
This flu season, the Center for Disease Contraction is recommending that all Americans, regardless of age or health condition, find a doorknob in a high traffic area, wrap their mouths around it, and vigorously lick and suck it until they contract an illness. We recommend sucking doorknobs covered in a visible film of human hand grease. But the fact is, sucking on any doorknob can increase the likelihood of exposing yourself and your family to deadly pathogens by as much as 450%.
An instructional video released on the CDC's website showcases the proper method for sucking doorknobs, while also providing tips for projecting all sneezes and coughs outward, sharing used Kleenexes and toilet paper with as many people as possible, eating three meals a day from local garbage cans, and dozens of other easy bacteria-spreading activities.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE is our number. We've been discussing intellectual property pretty much throughout the entire show, but you can bring up anything you want to discuss. 855-450-3733. We had started the show talking about Happy Birthday being overturned by the copyright on Happy Birthday being overturned by a federal judge, meaning that if you run a restaurant, you can now actually sing Happy Birthday to your clients. We'll get to some of the legal assessments of the case and what it means here in a moment, because this is a big case, and our toll-free number is, again, 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Joining you in studio, you have me, Ian.
And I'm Taryn P. Lupo.
What's that?
I was just going to say, I'm on Periscope if you want to watch behind the scenes.
Yeah, how do you do that?
You just go to, the easiest way is to go, Ian, did you post it on the...
I haven't gotten to it yet. Twitter.com/Taryn Lupo. You'll see the live links right there.
And maybe we can drop it over at Facebook so you just click a link.
Yeah, I'll put it over on our Facebook page here in a moment. But
my name's Mark.
Mark's here too. Let's go first to John in Canada. You're on Free Talk Live. John.
Hello.
Hey, you're on the air.
Yeah, Chicago won the Stanley Cup and is... Between Los Angeles, they won a few Stanley Cups, the powerhouses of the NHL. Are they going to do it again this year?
Brother, I have no idea. Your guess is as good as mine. I pay no attention to sports.
I wish them luck.
Yeah.
Do you have anything that actually matters to talk about?
Oh, come on. Let him...
come on.
Yeah, but we're talking about arenas here. Edmonton's got a brand new state-of-the-art arena they're building.
Who? Chicago or Edmonton? Sorry.
Edmonton. Canada. State-of-the-art.
What's that cost?
It's going to be the newest one. A lot of money. They got it from a businessman here, and they did it, though, and it's going to be quite fancy.
Hold on. How much are the taxpayers footing?
I don't know, but they've got it done. It's already built, and I've seen it down there, and it's mega, though, you know. And the Edmonton Oilers, they don't have a good team, but they seem to have a winning record in the preseason.
Now, what kind of team are we talking about? What's in Edmonton? Is it hockey?
Hockey and football.
And will the arena be used for both or just one?
No, just separately. The Edmonton Eskimos just have a regular arena. But some businessmen, they built it, and they've got it going. I've seen it down there. I've been down there.
Well, that is exciting. Thank you, John, for your call tonight. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. No. That's 855-450-3733.
Ian, I don't know a whole lot about sports, but usually my understanding is, aren't these stadiums basically a bunch of rich corporations who get the public to flip the bill to build the thing?
Generally, that's the way it goes. It's difficult to know specifically how it goes in each circumstance, but yeah. I mean, where are you going to build your stadium? Where are you going to take your major league sports team if they don't make you, if they don't give you a stadium? You know, you're in one city, they don't want to give you a stadium. Another city says, come here, we'll give you a stadium. Where do you want to play? I mean, well, you're going to want to go to that new city.
I remember, you know, it takes an enormous amount of space to build these things. And I remember when they did it in Atlanta, they used government domain, the eminent domain, and just cleared out some of the worst neighborhoods and built it was kind of a double move. They got rid of the hood.
Right. They destroyed the hood and turned it into a parking lot.
And they couldn't have done that without the government.
Yep, absolutely. How would you do that in that circumstance?
Yeah,
it'd be very difficult.
I'm curious how many, you know, stadiums are built by a private individual with their own money that doesn't touch government money. And I bet
why would they do that?
Stupid, I guess. It's bad business if someone else will pay for it.
It's bad business because at this point, it's absolutely ludicrous to do that. If you're talking about at least football, I mean, obviously, if you're talking about the local soccer team or something, they got to take what they can get. But if you're talking about a National Football League, every one of these teams, there are other aspiring cities out there that would just love to have that team come on over, and they will go ahead and build a stadium for them. So therefore, the city at which the team currently resides needs to come pretty close to matching. Obviously, there's some costs inherent in moving for a team, but ultimately, you got to make that owner happy.
All right, so I did a little bit of digging here, and it appears that the Edmonton Arena is indeed tax funded. So these to me are issues that matter. I don't give a damn who wins your little game, one team versus the other. There's always going to be some other team playing another team, and somebody's going to win one year versus another year.
It's like war. You know, this group of millionaires beats that group of millionaires, and all of us pay.
Well, at least in Canada, or at least Edmonton, that's the case. Here's the story from the Calgary Herald, CalgaryHerald.com, with Calgary Sports and Entertainment Corporation officials pitching the imposition of a ticket tax to finance part of an $890 million stadium arena fieldhouse proposal. Calgarians may be wondering how it will work. For answers, one needs only to head up to Highway 2 to the provincial capital, where the City of Edmonton and the Edmonton Arena Corporation have utilized such means to design and construct a new $605 million hockey arena in the city's downtown core. This story, by the way, came from August of this year. The Herald asked City of Edmonton Downtown Arena Project Executive Director Rick Davis to explain how it works. Number one, what is a ticket tax, and how does it work in Edmonton? The ticket tax is actually a surcharge added to the top of the ticket price for the life of the party's 35-year agreement to cover the estimated $125 million cost of designing and constructing the arena. Now, how does it go from $125 million to $605
million? This is the wonders of government financial magic.
Either way, it's a lot of money, and let's see, it was created by a city bylaw and is collected on all tickets to all NHL and other events held in the facility, except those with a ticket price of $7 or less. Two, who collects the tax? The tax is collected by the Edmonton Arena Corporation and remitted to the city in the amount of $375,000 on a quarterly basis to repay the upfront $125 million the city borrowed to finance the facility's design and construction.
Okay.
Who sets the tax? The city manager approves the tax percentage, which is currently set at 7%, but the Edmonton Arena Corporation calculates how much it needs annually to cover its costs. If the EAC is short the required amount, it's required to make up the difference, but can keep any excess tax money that it collects. Boy, this sounds like a real mess.
A clause in the deal enables the city to readjust the amount it receives quarterly to cover principal and cost of borrowing after 15 years if necessary. So it does sound like the city borrowed the money rather than implementing its own tax on everybody. So maybe actually not everyone in Edmonton is paying for this.
If the city borrowed the money, then the city has to pay it back.
But that's why they're implementing a tax on the tickets in order to pay it back. So then in theory, only the people who actually go to the arena would have to pay the tax.
Okay.
So maybe it's not so bad as it initially seemed. What else does the tax cover, asks the article here. Since the city is responsible for maintaining the downtown arena structure, the tax provides the city an additional $1.5 million annually that goes into a reserve fund to cover future maintenance costs. And finally, who gets credit for the ticket tax contribution? The city of Edmonton contends the tax is a public contribution because it covers the amount borrowed by the city through a taxation structure imposed by a city bylaw and paid by the public. However, the EAC argues the ticket tax should actually count as its contribution because if not for the tax, it could charge more for the ticket and keep the additional revenue. So there you go. There's a little bit of information about the money behind this fancy new sports facility.
Well, fancy, it doesn't sound that fancy. It only had $100
million. $605 million. The $125 million was the amount the city borrowed to finance the design and the construction of it.
Besides design and construction?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
So, and then the city, after it gets paid back, I assume it just keeps getting paid and getting paid and getting paid.
It's supposed to last for 35 years.
Oh, so I thought supposedly that they'd pay it back quick.
Supposedly, they'll get rid of it after 35 years, but we all know how governments go.
Yeah, just a quick little change in a vote. No one will ever notice it. Buried in with something, billion other bills.
All things considered, this sounds like one of the least offensive city-involved stadium constructions.
It does sound that way.
More like a loan, really. Yeah.
But they are still using the government in order to finance their building of this arena. And as far as I'm concerned, if you can't afford to build your own damn arena, then you shouldn't be able to have an arena.
Just buy the one of the failed organization that built the last one.
And how many house owners did they force out of the way to build it?
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you want to join us here, 855-450-3733. We can talk about intellectual property or the 91-year-old woman who's being charged over 260,000 Auschwitz deaths. It's Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Want gold, but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault, providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. Digital, spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want here, toll-free, 855-450-3733. Happy birthday, finally legal to sing and perform in any circumstance. At least that's the way it sounds from the story over at the LA Times we opened this show with tonight. If you're just tuning in, maybe you don't know that happy birthday has for decades been heavily prosecuted by its copyright holder, or at least the company that thought they held the copyrights on Happy Birthday to You. But in point of fact, according to the story at the LA Times, a judge in a federal court ruled that no evidence existed that the Summy Corporation, the original company to assert a copyright claim, ever legally obtained the rights to the Happy Birthday to You song from whomever wrote it, and nobody's really sure who that is. Ultimately, it was Warner who bought it from the Summy Corporation, who had sold it to the Birch Tree Group, and then Warner bought the Birch Tree Group entirely. So Warner, since 1988, has been vigorously pursuing anybody who would dare to sing Happy Birthday, including every restaurant who ever brought someone a free piece of cake. I mean, this ridiculous amount of enforcement on this very ancient song that was published originally as Good Morning to You, written by kindergarten teachers back in 1893. And here's more from the story from the LA Times, but I want to let you know about ExpressCoin.com. It's a great way to get some Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin. Cryptocurrencies like that are available, and they're easy to get through ExpressCoin. In fact, it's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive to go through ExpressCoin.com. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check. Whether in the U.S. or Canada, they can likely help you at ExpressCoin.com. You can do it from your smartphone by downloading their app, and use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee whatsoever. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. Tuesday's ruling, that's yesterday, means that the song is now considered public work and is free for everyone to use without having fear to pay, without fear of having to pay for it, according to a statement from the plaintiff's attorneys. This from the LA Times. Jennifer Nelson, one of the filmmakers, the filmmaker plaintiffs and owner of Good Morning to You Productions, called the decision a great victory for musicians, artists, and people around the world who've waited decades for this. Robert Brunais, a George Washington University law professor who has extensively researched the copyright history of the song, says the ruling does not explicitly place Happy Birthday to You in the public domain, however. Brené said on Tuesday night it does leave open some questions. If the Hill sisters, the original authors of Good Morning to You, which is the same musical content that backs Happy Birthday, didn't convey the rights to Summy Corporation, then is there someone else that might still own them? With Mildred Hill dead for nearly a century now, Brané said, figuring out who owned the
she
rights...
She won't be telling any tales.
Yeah, at this point, would be quite an interesting job. The plaintiff's attorneys have said they will move to qualify the lawsuit as a class action in an effort to recoup millions of dollars in licensing fees that Warner Chappell has collected on the tune over the years. Wow.
What about the companies that have gone out of business and sold this to them? So this is an interesting run, right? Like Warner bought it in, you said, 89?
88.
88. Prior to that, some company collected yep. these fees and sold it off and whatever. No one's
those records can't exist anymore, right? I mean, who's going to hold on to all that?
Nobody's talking about recouping that money or any kind of, you know,
I mean, the judgment's going to go that far back, you think?
I don't know. That is...
I had no idea it was going, like, it was completely reversing it. I thought that they meant from this point on they couldn't collect.
Well, I don't know what it means when they say here they're going to move to qualify the lawsuit as a class action. Does that mean there's another suit they'd have to file, or can you qualify a suit as class action after a decision's been made?
Well, if there's enough people who have basically the same suit, you can combine mm-hmm. those suits into a class action.
But after a judge has made a ruling?
Well, this isn't the ruling on the case as much as it's a ruling on sort of whether the case could go forward or something,
you might
right?
be right about that. Well, the ruling is essentially opening up this this song for use, so... Yeah, I'm not sure about the legal details here. Mark Rifkin, one of Nelson's attorneys, said the plaintiffs will pursue Warner for royalties paid since at least 1988 and could also ask the company to repay royalties that have been collected all the way back to 1935. It's not clear how much money that could entail.
I don't see why Warner would be responsible for that. They didn't pay for it.
I assume when they bought the rights, it comes with it, doesn't it?
Yeah, do they? If you buy a company, don't you take on the liabilities of the other?
Don't you take on the liability? Yeah.
This is intellectual property. It's not a company.
I imagine that at some point it'll be limited, but yeah, it'll be interesting to see how the rest of this pans out. A third of the profits from licensing the song still go to a designated charity of the Hill family, the Association for Childhood Education International, which promotes global education efforts for children and the professional growth of educators. The association's 2012 nonprofit tax return, the most recent available, indicates that it received $754,000 in royalties. Warner could still appeal the judge's decision, but it will have to ask the judge to permit the appeal to go forward. The company has not indicated that it will do so.
I wonder if the charity has to give back all that money it's been getting every year.
Oh, no, we're not going to do it to a charity, you know.
I hope not. I mean, they should probably leave the charity alone, but who knows?
Who knows at this point? You're going to be feel pretty burned if you paid tens of thousands of dollars to have
I'd want it back.
Happy Birthday in your movie.
Illegally. So there you go. That's the latest on the Happy Birthday story. You're welcome to share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE. In sort of a related story, the Telegraph over in the UK has a story about a woman who's 91 years old and is being charged with over 260,000 Auschwitz deaths. And I say this is related because this is old news, right? Like, this lady's 91. We're talking about something that happened, you know, generations ago in the late 30s and the early 40s here. She's being charged now, actually specifically 1944. She was a radio operator at the Nazi-run concentration camp from April through July. 91-year-old woman in Germany has been charged as an accessory to the murder of 260,000 people. The woman, who has not been named under German privacy laws, is accused of having served as a member of the SS at the concentration camp. The latest is the latest in a series of attempts by German prosecutors to bring surviving Holocaust perpetrators to justice while there is still time. Now, look, I don't think. Obviously, I think the Holocaust is a horrible thing and it's atrocious, but we're talking about a different person, right? I mean, Mark, you went to prison for 9 years, 8 or 9 years after you were age 17. You're now in your 40s. You've got a family. You've got a son. You've got a wife. You've got pigs. You know, you're a completely different man than you were at age 17.
There's no doubt in my mind. I mean, I don't know this lady, but come on. How could you be the same person you were in 1944 as you are in 2015 today? Leave this poor old lady alone to die.
Yeah, I don't see any particular value in going after the lady. I mean, are you going to make people whole? Because
no,
of this, because it seems like people just want to beat this drum, you know,
there's
further
probably
and further.
Not even survivors that can prosecute her. It's probably like
there
somebody's family.
No, there are a few survivors. They had they had a case that was just last month, and I imagine this case is based to some extent on that case, where it was a guy who. I think he was an accountant of some sort.
The bookkeeper of Auschwitz.
The bookkeeper of
Oscar
Auschwitz.
Oscar Gröning.
Yep. And
we'll
they
continue.
Prosecuted him.
You can join us here. Maybe you think this lady should have the book thrown at her and locked into the clink until she dies. I don't get it. 855-450-FREE. Please explain this to me. 855-450-3733.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, Cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon. through saveatpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Maybe you think this 91-year-old former Nazi, and maybe she still is a Nazi. I don't know. I would hope not. You'd hope people would move on and, you know, change their mind about the mistakes they made in the past. We don't actually know who this lady is. She's being prosecuted in Germany now. They won't release her name due to German privacy laws, which is unusual because here in the United States, if somebody's being prosecuted, their name's plastered everywhere. There's no privacy unless you're under the age of 18. But if you think this lady should be prosecuted for the being an accessory to the murder of people at Auschwitz, I want to hear from you because I don't think she should. And that's not because I support what happened in Nazi Germany. I certainly don't.
That's how people that that want to see this lady prosecuted would be happy to paint you. Is essentially, you either want to see this lady prosecuted or you want to see every Jew on the planet dead.
And well,
speaking
ridiculous.
As a Jew, that's a bunch of freaking hyperbole put out by people who just don't want to have a conversation.
So you can call in.
The question I would have is that how long – I don't want to know about statute of limitations. I can read the law. I don't need you to tell me about it. But how long is somebody sort of morally culpable of things?
How long is somebody the same somebody that they were whenever it was that whatever it did, they did happened?
And, I mean, obviously there's different situations. In the case of this lady, she's a – how old was she? 18?
She's very young. I'd have to do the math. I'm not sure.
She was a young woman who joined the SS, which was the up-and-coming political organization at the time. That's what the patriotic people decided to do. You know, all she was doing was what she was told was the right thing to do.
What would happen if you didn't do what you were told to do in Nazi Germany? I suspect it wouldn't be
good
things.
I don't think you had to join the SS.
Okay.
Joining the SS is something a bit more. That's kind of like the pages in the Republican and Democratic parties
that go
up there. And but, I mean, you know, she wanted to have some kind of career. This was a way to do it.
I imagine also it was a popular thing to do back in the day, you know, to join the SS, and then you really didn't realize what you'd gotten yourself into until it got a little too late, and then what do you do?
Yeah, and how many of them actually knew the horrors that were going on?
She was at Auschwitz.
She was there. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm not claiming she didn't know, but maybe she didn't. Right, she was the radio operator. Does that mean she was nearby when they were setting people ablaze or executing them? I don't know.
I don't know the answer to that either.
And to me, it doesn't matter because it's, God, how many years has it been?
Years ago.
70 years, 60 years?
I mean,
years?
If you're a victim or your family was, I mean, those people are not going to let it go. They're going to want justice 60 years later.
That's what I want to hear. I want to hear from somebody who thinks this lady should be prosecuted, age 91. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Here we are in 2015. And the German government is spending their time and taxpayer dollars doing this stuff. Jim is in Phoenix. You're listening via TuneIn. Jim, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Taryn, and Mark.
Hey, Terrence.
Yeah.
If somebody burned the studio down with you in it right now, let's say your children were watching, and 80 years later they caught the dude, should he be forgiven?
Hey, man, I'm on your side on that. I didn't say
they
should.
That's an easy question, yes.
So you think they should go after this lady?
I think, yeah, if someone burned my family down, I'd have a hard time forgiving it.
So you think they should go after this lady?
I do.
Oh,
not
okay.
That a pothead dirtbag that would remember, but the very first point I ever made on my very first call, Free Talk Live, so-called, was in reference to Auschwitz was not closed down by potheads carrying flowers and saying peace, love, and understanding.
It was shut down essentially by accident, right? Like the United States military didn't go into Germany to rescue Jews.
No, the Russians closed down Auschwitz, and then they reopened it a month later as a prisoner of war camp for their own.
Fine. It doesn't matter to me which side managed to get that particular camp.
It matters to me, Mark, because my dad was old enough to be. I love, by the way, you're just following orders defense for the people that committed the mass murder. It was a mass murder factory that the woman that worked at knew what was going on, and she knew that she was answerable to justice for her entire life, that she got to live. in peace and freedom, no thanks to the U.S. Army,
well,
by
wait,
the way.
What exactly was a war crime about these things? Because many people have argued that the Nuremberg trials were essentially illegitimate. Now, look, I don't think any of these things
Mark,
these people did were good.
Can I ask you a question?
I assume, if you don't want to answer mine, just go ahead and ask me one.
When you say many people, can we keep the debate between me and you and don't make these bring these arguments from the outside about many
okay.
people?
Well, my debate would be that at some point or another, it becomes just disgusting to keep on chasing after geriatrics that can
really?
Not even control
okay,
their bowels.
Parents,
yeah.
If somebody burns Mark and you and Ian to death, then it will be disgusting if 80 years later will be let go.
I'm actually kind of agreeing with you on this because I really feel that because it's up to the family.
Kind of?
Up to the victims. It's up to the victims if they want to let it go it's been 50 years. Okay, I have no pony in this.
I don't think the victims are making a decision in this case. It's the German government doing it.
No, I think it should be.
Justice has never been up to the victims.
It needs to be. That's the way I would handle it. Is the families that were actually hurt would be the ones that decide. If they say, "Hey, let it go. It's been 50 years," then that's fine.
But you're saying don't let it go.
I'm saying it should be decided by.
But you are saying that this should go on.
I kind of feel
if you were the family member, you would say, "Put this old lady in a prison cell."
If someone burned down and killed my family, I'd still want justice if they're 90 years old.
What if? But this lady is a radio operator, right? Like, she didn't kill anybody. This is the argument.
She's an accessory, they're claiming. Accessory to murder. By operating the radio, she assisted in the murder of these people.
What about the people that drove? What about the people that baked the bread so that she could eat, so that she could then operate the radio so that somebody or another somewhere down the
presumably
line.
Presumably, the chef would also be an accessory.
Like, who, you can't just kill off everybody that was in Germany from up till 1945. So I don't know who it is, and this is why the bookkeeper of Auschwitz was an important case, because now you're going to see a whole bunch of these. Essentially, every living 90-year-old that wore an SS uniform is now going to be brought up.
It's a tough thing, because I wish it was black and white, and it's not. That'd be like saying, you know what, all of you have paid taxes at some point, and that tax money is used now to drone children and murder them. So you're culpable.
Should the people who built the ovens also be culpable?
That's what I'm saying. How far does it go back? How soon is it? I mean, are you culpable if you pay taxes that you bought bombs and that we're dropping on brown people right now?
At this point in World War I, there was the Armenian massacre that went on, and they can't get Turkey, a country that no one is alive in that even participated in this situation. They can't get them to admit that this occurred, so they can't even get them to say, "I'm sorry our dads did this to you or our granddads did this to you." And I'd ask you this. What if in this weird situation occurs and tomorrow somehow the Japanese government takes over the U.S. government? Don't act like the United States government hasn't taken other places' governments, so it could certainly, I suppose, it happen in an alternative future. What if they wanted to prosecute everybody who was involved in dropping A-bombs on Nagasaki and Hiroshima? What if they wanted to do that?
That's a great question.
Because this is lots of innocent people were killed. Many, many innocent people were killed. Now, suddenly, when everybody's feeling all indignant about, hey, let's go after the SS lady who's 91, what are they going to think about Americans being prosecuted for dropping bombs on Nagasaki? You can decide that it was necessary or not necessary, but consider that the Nazis weren't trying to kill Jews initially. Initially, what they wanted to do was get them out of the country, but no other countries would let them do it.
The U.S. turned around the ship of the damned. Probably
a whole bunch of countries did it. Yeah. Now, I'm not saying that this makes it okay. It's not okay to murder people. It's not okay. But I would ask you need to look back at the times and what was important. I don't think it was okay to drop an A-bomb on Japan.
That's a war crime.
But it doesn't change the fact that I don't think it's worth prosecuting anybody over it. Yeah. So I am being consistent. I am not calling for the head of the person who flew the Enola Gay. I am simply saying that at some point or another, you have to put things aside and heal.
Somebody loaded those bombs on that airplane, too.
What about all
multiple
them?
People.
What about everybody who was in the Air Force?
Toll-free number tonight. If you want to share your thoughts in the remaining moments.
What about the radio operator?
You have time. Because that's what this lady did. She was the radio operator at Auschwitz. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. 855-450-3733. Join us here on Free Talk Live.
For P150, P150GA, P150LK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
This is The Onion Week in Review. In local news, a succession of terrible events failed to befall a 33-year-old riding a longboard to his digital media job Monday. Shocked bystanders helplessly watched as media developer Jake Reston skated safely through Manhattan traffic without flipping over on his obnoxiously oversized skateboard and smashing his stupid f***ing face into the pavement, with many saying they were horrified at the sight of the floppy-haired little shit walking into his office unscathed.
It was one of the most horrible things I've ever seen. He wasn't even hit by a car. I was just praying that someone would step in and throw him off a stupid little skateboard and punch him right in the mouth.
In other news, a study finds owning a cool leather jacket is more rewarding than raising a child. A community garden sprouts the first condom wrapper of spring, and a little turtle gorges on an entire raspberry.
Tonight in the cabin, school marm's telling about how they talk about corpulation down the school. Only a fool needs telling how to screw. Just let the pecker guide you. But come on, listen anyhow.
This is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
BlakeDevelopment.net is a global leader in website creation, app development, and online marketing, catering to businesses of all sizes. There's really no job too big or too small for BlakeDevelopment.net. Do you have an idea for a killer app, but you don't know how to code it? Are you missing out on online sales? Or maybe your business needs help with social media? Websites start at just $200, and they're offering 3 years of free domain registry. Yes, they take Bitcoin. 844-SITE-123. BlakeDevelopment.net, 844-SITE-123.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We have time for you to join us if you dial in toll-free right now at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's a 91-year-old woman, they won't say what her name is being prosecuted in Germany for working at Auschwitz as a radio operator. here decades upon decades, generations upon generations later. Is this appropriate? Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. And Free Talk Live is brought to you by Keenvention. It's coming up October 30th through November 1st. It's a great excuse to come up to New Hampshire during the fall. Might be a little chilly, but there was actually one Keenvention where it was actually like t-shirt weather during the day. So you never know really what you're going to get up here in November during that time of year, but it will be a pretty time to come up. It's just past peak, so it's not the optimal peak leaf peeping season. But you'll still see some pretty colors, I think, while you're here typically during Keenvention. Of course, the scenery isn't the only reason to come up. It's to see the activists, to meet the people that you hear about on the show. Many of the voices that you hear on the show. Taryn, you're going to be heading up the New Movers panel this year.
I will be there. I'm very excited. It's my first time I've been to a Keenvention.
Yeah, and basically your panel is going to focus on people who've moved to New Hampshire, mostly as part of the Free State Project. I think all of them are Free State Project early movers. People who've moved here within the last year, and what's it like? You know, what's that experience like for people coming here? You were a long time coming, having been visiting here for like a decade before finally moving. Others, not so much. There's one guy who, I don't know if he's on your panel, but there's one guy I know who, you know, found the Free State Project and decided to pick up his life and move within a month. So everybody's got a different story to tell, and you've got about, I think, four panelists on your panel, plus you. And that'll be one of the 11 different panels that we're going to be having, covering all kinds of different activism, from getting active at the state house, the political process. We've got the legislative panel and the political action panel, so two sort of politically minded panels this year. There's the cop block panel, the old school panel, which will kind of be a counter to your panel, Taryn. So we've got a bunch of people who've been here for several years or more, close to 10 years, going to be on the old school panel. So it'll be a lot of different perspectives on the activism scene here in New Hampshire. And if you're new to the show, then you may not know that the reason we're here is the Free State Project, the idea of focusing our liberty activists in one place, having people who care about freedom move to one geographic location and get active. Turns out that really works. Like, proof of concept, it's happening here. And Keenvention focuses on some of the activism that's gone on over the last year. We'll have some keynote speakers, including Chris Reitman, an Oath Keeper, who made headlines this year for heading up one of the guards outside of the recruiting center, the military recruiting center here that made a lot of headlines earlier this year. He's going to be speaking. Great activist. Lots of different things happening at Keenvention. Plus, you'll get out of the hotel, and you'll be able to go and do some activism in town here in Keene. So you can go cop blocking in the evening hours if you prefer to get out and do something activist-like. Or you can go and do there's a bonfire on Friday night, which is going to be a lot of fun. And then the Halloween costume dance party on Saturday night. So there's a lot to do at Keenvention. You can come and join us October 30th through November 1st. It's all of $60. They get you in for the entire weekend. You cannot find a hotel convention for a weekend that is that affordable anywhere. Keenvention.info. You can also pay for your tickets with Bitcoin. Keenvention.info. We'll look forward to seeing you there. Alan is on the line in Charleston, West Virginia, listening to WVTS. Hey, Alan.
Hi, thanks for taking my call.
Sure.
Long-time listener, first-time caller.
Welcome, sir.
And I appreciate the fervor with which you espouse freedom, and I share that.
Thank you.
I'm a little concerned about what seems to be a bit of moral bankruptcy, though. Is there a statute of limitations on murder or accessory to murder? I don't know German law. I know we have our laws here, is my first comment.
Well, I wouldn't.
And then my second comment.
This isn't about statute of limitations. This is about sort of a. This is talking about,
well,
really.
Is she culpable? Is she culpable or not?
Kill anybody?
Can you say? Pardon me?
She didn't kill anybody.
She had a hand in killing people, did she not?
Well,
she was communicating commands from Hitler to Auschwitz to. Are you telling me that as a radio operator, she didn't know what was going on?
I don't know precisely if she knows what's going on, but let's say that she had a general, she had a rough picture. You know, I mean, that seems like a fair thing to say.
Okay. Secondly, if you're going to draw the parallel between Auschwitz and Hiroshima, the motivation of Germans in Auschwitz, you conveniently say, was they wanted to get rid of Jews, but they didn't have anywhere to send them. So, okay, let's kill them. Well, the motivation in Hiroshima was the flagship of the United States Navy, the carrier of the United States Navy, had been hit by two kamikaze planes. That we had just been through Iwo Jima and Okinawa, losing hundreds, not thousands, of soldiers. And so Our government made a decision that if we don't do something drastic, we will continue to lose thousands and thousands of soldiers. Okay,
that's the story we're told,
that's the story I'm told. Really, you're not a student of history.
Well, I think that there's something you're leaving out that's really important is the Japanese government attempted to sue for peace in a couple of occasions, certainly through Russia. And then there's
while they were sending kamikaze bombers.
Sure, they were fighting, as were other as was the United States. It was a war.
Nobody had ever fought that way before yet. Nobody had ever sacrificed their own lives in such a heinous way to. In any sort of war effort up until that point, and it terrified the U.S., and it terrified the citizens.
So mass murder is the appropriate response to that?
They were committing mass murder to begin with.
Not the people of Japan. The military people were killing people, but the people in Japan weren't doing that.
There is military strategy where you have to win the war.
So you would, if Japan dropped some nuclear weapons on the United States in the same circumstances, you'd be fine with that, huh?
That's the problem in 21st century America. Everybody thinks that there's war can be won without collateral damage. War, by definition, is war, and collateral damage is going to happen.
Wait, my understanding was I thought the Japanese tried to surrender twice, and they just wanted to use the bomb to drive a point home
to Russia.
To Russia.
But that's the alternate theory here. That's
the rewriting of history. That's the rewriting of history.
That's what you're saying. Well, hold on. Remember, history's written by winners. So rewriting is going to be necessary in order to get the truth. I don't know the answer. However, I am somewhat skeptical.
The Russians are rewriting history now?
Okay, well, listen. My understanding of the concentration camps is that the Jewish concentration camps was that they were used for labor, and that they only began doing the final solution situation because they saw
the killing. You want to say the final solution?
I'm not scared of saying it. They were murdering Jews, millions of Jews. Now that I've said it, can I go on? So that they were murdering millions of Jews in order to not have to release them because they knew that was going to be bad for them. That was a strategic.
Why would that be bad for them?
Because they would kill them. The Jews would turn sides and then take sides with the Allies, turn over whatever information they had, join up with guns and attempt to kill the Germans. So it was a strategic move on their part, killing them. Now that it's strategic, does that make the killing of millions of Jews okay to you?
Wasn't that a strategic? If that was a strategic move, then what's wrong with the strategic move at Hiroshima?
I'm asking you, because you're claiming that it's because it's a strategic move to kill civilians.
He's not saying it was okay. Mark, you're not saying it was okay.
I'm not saying it's okay. I'm saying you're saying the killing of Jews or killing of Japanese civilians is okay.
The Jews were not a nation, and the Jews were not an army. All right, you're presupposing that they somehow could have risen up. Are you kidding? They walk like sheep to the train.
Yes, but once they were
gold stars on their jackets.
If they were
fighting, they had no intention of fighting.
I think the concern of the Germans was that if a camp of Jews was captured, that those Jews could then be armed by the Allies and used as additional troops against them.
Thanks, Alan.
I don't think that
that's
okay. I don't think any of this excuses any of it.
What am I going to do about that?
The German government.
If I'm a German, I have a final solution for that potential rebellion. That's what you're saying?
That's what I'm claiming, that they, a good portion of the reason they did that.
And does that justify that?
No, it does not justify it. I'm not justifying any of this.
You're the one who's justifying mass murder.
Because I told you, Ian, as soon as you say that the radio operator lady should be let go, that you want to see every Jew on the planet be murdered. That is the only argument that people will make in the opposite direction.
Look, Alan's the only one arguing for murder here. You're the one justifying killing innocent people.
I'm absolutely arguing for collateral damage.
That's murder, sir. It's murder.
Right. Okay. No, hold on. You can't call it collateral damage. Let's call it what it is. Let's call it the murder of women and children and innocent Japanese men.
Well, that's exactly what it
was. That was the point he was making when I said the final solution. He didn't want to let me go on it.
Well, it's not murder when the U.S. government does it, according to him. Thanks, Alan, for the call tonight.
We'll be back tomorrow night. You can join us online in the meantime. Check out Taran on his website, taranlupo.com, and subscribe to him on the Twitter as well.
The tweet.
See you tomorrow.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is up $7 at $1,132 per ounce. Silver is 11 cents higher at $14.93 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $230. Robertson Roberts is your trusted source for physical precious metals for nearly 40 years. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, September 23rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.83 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,130 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $232. Antiwar.com reports Syrian warplanes have carried out one of their most intense series of airstrikes in weeks against the ancient city of Palmyra on the outskirts of the strategically important central city of Tadmor, killing at least 38 fighters from the Islamic State. The attacks continued for hours. The Islamic State captured Palmyra and Tadmor back in May, and while most of the focus has been on the danger the Islamic State poses to the antiquities in Palmyra, the capture of the area has given them a core through which to attack deeper west and deeper south into the country. The latest round of airstrikes likely reflects Syria's military growing emboldened by the receipt of new warplanes from Russia, allowing them more freedom to carry out airstrikes than they'd previously been able to with the remnants of their air force. Syria has lost some of its most important air bases in recent weeks, but Russian specialists along the Latakian coast have been expanding the airfields there, with the Syrian military mostly losing conflicts on the ground. Relying on air power is becoming one of the few ways they can stop the Islamic State at bay. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Martin Shkreli, CEO of Turing Pharmaceuticals, has defended the 5,000% price increase of the drug Daraprim, often used to treat toxoplasmosis in people with compromised immune systems like AIDS patients. In August, Turing Pharmaceuticals acquired Daraprim, which was first developed in 1953, and the company immediately increased the price of the drug from $13.